Welcome, Lumpia lovers, to another Lumpia cast. My name is PG Patricio, and this is going to be hard to follow up the last webcast we had two nights ago with the National Film Society, but I got to give them a props and heads shout out to Steve and Patrick of the National Film Society for raising $1,500 in just 3 hours. You guys, we're close to almost 2 days left in this campaign, and I should be sweating bullets, but we're having fun with this, and I am very, very, very happy the fact that where are we at now for Kickstarter? 297 backers, so as of now, it is 9:30 p.m. on a Friday night, so I ain't got shit to do on a Friday night, but prepare for FPAC tomorrow. 297 backers, pledging a $24,084. Right now it's these 3 days to go, but by the time we end this webcast tonight, we're gonna be down to 2 days. 2 days. 2 days. I apologize for the Filipino time. It is gonna be always Filipino time with the Loopy cast because we're Filipino. But I was taking a nap, to be honest with you. It was a crazy, crazy last day. Last night was our Los Angeles screening of Lumpia, the 10th anniversary screening of Lumpia, over at CGV Cinemas over at K-Town. And it was, it's still processing in my head. It was a crazy, crazy, crazy experience. I mean, not only to watch the film again on the big screen, but then to experience it with a full packed audience here in L.A., and a lot of people definitely showed up, a lot of folks who inspire me as a filmmaker and as also just someone living here in LA, and it was just cool. I mean, anytime that we're able to do these events and people actually show up, it's always humbling, and a lot of moments it's weird because I guess I trip out whenever someone who's seen it for the first time and they're watching the movie and they say how great and oh they enjoyed it and it kind of shows that I guess the movie still people still relate to it. So I have guests tonight. I don't know. I made I put a call out to everyone. There's viewers now watching. Let me share this link. And make sure that everyone knows that we're on live. I don't know how many people are getting tonight because it's Friday night, but I do see people watching this now, so welcome. Welcome to the show. 3 days left, so there's not going to be many webcasts, any opportunities to do this, but I'm starting to get used to this. So if you continue to watch, maybe we'll continue this past the Kickstarter campaign, right? All right, so let's see. I'm going to check the YouTube page because the one thing is I don't have a driver. So any of my cast, any of my crew members, you know what to do. Text me. Let me know you're online. I'm going to invite you. I am looking for my sidekick tonight because it is hard for me to multitask and my Mac is still running. It's still not running well. It's getting there. So... okay, so again, we are at 297 backers. I haven't decided yet whether I want to drink tonight, but just to get through tonight, I'm still relying on Superman here. What's going on? Talk to me here. Let's see. Comment page. I remember I go to a comment page. Let's see. What do people want to talk about tonight? As we, before we invite our first guest here, let's see. All right, so here we go. Welcome, Lillian Perjoles, back to the Lumpio webcast. Can you hear me, Lil?
Yeah, I can. Can you hear me?
I can hear you.
Good.
We're getting used to this. I think we should make this a regular TV talk show. We should sell. We should try to pitch this ABS-CBN and TFC.
No, I don't think. Let's do GMA. Let's do GMA this time.
GMA, okay.
Yeah.
You guys listening? GMA, ABS-CBN. You wanna outbid each other for the rights to the Lumpia cast? We're listening. We're taking all offers right now. Because
God
knows we need something to do after this Kickstarter campaign and it ends on Monday night. So
more shots, man.
More shots. Okay, wait. I'm waiting for more people to join up on this joint. But can you help me drive and check the comments page and see if, what people are saying, because it's hard to follow up the National Film Society. You know, if
it kind of is. There
it is. It is. But that won't stop us from getting our pledges tonight.
No way.
Because you know what? They raise the bar, but we can break the bar.
We can,
you know,
maintain that bar and go higher a little bit.
Even though we're not the bar, we're not Bamboo and Prometheus
Brown. We're not the bar, Kada.
But I do want to announce, while we're actually talking about the bar, Bamboo and Geo are going to be offering a reward for Kickstarter, which once I post up sometime tonight.
Okay.
But they're going to be... Should I announce it? I haven't posted up. I was gonna do a sneak preview.
Well, I think you should announce like the other giveaways we had before this, and then like kind of.
Oh, okay. Preview it.
Like,
all right.
You were having some, like, you had something yesterday that I didn't even like know you were doing, like
what
for
did
the
I have
new
yesterday?
For a new EP.
Oh well. Oh, okay. So here's the thing. All right, and I'm sure the Thriller from Sarah Manella challenge was yesterday. And I completely forgot about it because of the whole screening. And I was supposed to bring it up at the after party at the Park's Finest, which, and I think the food was so great. And I was such in a hurry to grab my cornbread bibinca that I completely forgot. I got so caught up into the love and the food and just the talking to people that the next thing you know, I saw the phone. It was like 12:05 already, and I won't say anything, but you know. There were other people in that room that was trying to compete for the Thriller from Sarah Manila, and it was my fault. But I'm still proud to announce that Danny Rubio has won the Thriller from Sarah Manila. And
holy crap.
Executive producer of Lumpia 2. So, Danny Rubio.
I'm not even an executive producer.
He's watching right now because I see him tweeting. I think it's only fitting that he becomes executive producer of Lumpia 2 because...
Definitely.
He is literally one of our hardcore Lupia fans and really great guy, also from the Bay. So it makes sense. So congratulations.
Woo!
You are part of the Lupia crew. I just got to get you on. I forgot to make all these things today. I've just been so...
I know.
Wanted to rest.
Can we get him on, like, at least on Monday night?
You know, we'll get him on. I mean, you know, it's Danny knows this more than anything, but... none of this will ever, the reward won't even exist if this campaign is not a success. So everything, all the pledges, all the rewards, all the awards that we're giving away left and right, none of that will come to fruition if the Kickstarter campaign doesn't hit its goal by midnight.
Wait, so I can't get my rock and roll DVD till we finish this whole thing?
You know what? Yeah, you know what? That's actually one of the popular awards, and it's sad to say that even the signed rock and roll DVD by Quark Canaris.
I want mine.
You're going to have to buy it the way everyone else is buying it, you know. But I think it's only offered in the Philippines, so that's what makes it even extra special and rare. And it's signed by Quark and Diego. So, you know how... That's even super rare, you know?
That's even...
Because Quark is, like, in Hollywood somewhere working. You got to find him. But now you have it all into one DVD.
Well, yeah, because you have to find him in some corporate office somewhere in L.A., and it's like, I don't know where he works.
No. He has the Quark Cave. It's like the Bat Cave.
It's the Quark Cave.
Yeah. I got to give a shout-out to Quark. He came out to the Lupia screening. last night. And he saw the movie for the first time, and he was very...
There are some fun pictures from the Lumpia screening, because he was there's pictures with him with Wills Portacio.
Yes, so there were two guests from our we haven't premiered the next episode, but in the Geeking Out While Eating Lumpia, the new episode should be premiering this weekend. It's supposed to be tomorrow morning, but as you can tell, I'm not editing right now. I'm actually hosting this webcast, so I'm shooting for Sunday morning. So Will Smith is guest three, and the fact that Quark and Wilsh were together, it's like seeing, for me as a geek, like, wow, it's like Quark.
That was a really good screening yesterday, Quark, man.
Yeah, it was a good screening.
Awesome screening. There was like some sightings at that screening yesterday.
Yeah.
So I saw Icy Ice, man.
Yeah, Ice was there. Yeah, I don't have the VIP list in front of me. It's weird. Like, I saw them on paper, and then I saw the pictures afterward this morning. Stanley being Mirador took all these cool pictures, and yet all I can think of was like, what the fuck was I doing? Why wasn't I talking to everyone? You know, like, I didn't get to really mingle a lot. And I was like, whoa, like, he was there?
But you were talking to so many people that you forgot.
I know, but you know what? I may be talking to them, but my head was elsewhere. It's like, it's just one of those things that you know, it's hard to do these kind of events when you're talking to people and stuff. It's like I'm trying to, have like a normal conversation, but then like, you know, you're trying to cut it off right away so you can talk to everyone. And you can see in the corner of your eye all these people are trying to say hi, give you props, and like it's just before they leave. And so it becomes not really a conversation, but like, oh hey, what's going on? And you know, move on. And especially the people who you just met, you know, it's hard. It's hard. And I really want to know. Like I guess. You know, I guess it hasn't processed yet that, you know, that people still love this movie 10 years later. You know?
Right.
And, I gotta admit that they gave me a good tip. One of my good friends gave me a tip of never apologizing for anything.
Ooh.
Screening. One of the attendees told me, never apologize. Never say I'm so sorry for doing this and that. But it was a sarcastic apology, right? I just apologized because of the fact that in the main ending scene, spoiler alert, if people haven't seen Lumpia, but I'm assuming if you're watching this right now, you've seen Lumpia.
Yeah.
But the spoiler alert where it's the big Moon reveal and, you know, Kuya comes in and actually stops Moon and sticks the Lumpia in his mouth, and then that Lumpia that he eats, it's like the pivotal moment, and it's not Lumpia he has. It's not authentic Lumpia that he's holding. And I apologize for it because, you know, it's actually a Jack in the Box egg roll, you know, when I shot it.
Oh, I gotta tell everybody, man.
Yeah, I know. So I felt it's like blasphemy that, you know, in the key scene.
It's okay.
But you know, but anyway, that's the thing. My friends told me, don't apologize. Everyone loves it. No one wants to hear. You know, it's like it's one of those things that, you know, it's like I cringe whenever I watch that scene. I mean, I cringe during a lot of moments watching that movie, but that scene, because if only we had spent just a few extra hours just to wait for the Filipino restaurant to open around the corner. we had to like shoot it right away, and like Jack in the Box, as you know, it's open 24 hours.
It's pretty early, man. That looked like it was early morning Daly City.
Yeah.
The fog was nice and thick right when the rice cookers were starting up.
I'd like to show some pictures. There's some pictures here that...
Yeah, pictures? From last night?
Yeah. Yeah.
Give me one sec. I gotta look at these YouTube comments. Hold on.
Yes, Sidekick. Come on. You gotta do your job. Alright. As we're waiting there, so we're still 297 backers, and I have to do something crazy tonight to get this up, because we're nearing the 50% goal, which means a lot just to hit the halfway point. So I want to do something special for backer number 300, just because 300 has been a goal of mine all week, and we've never hit 300 backers. But 300 backers, I don't know yet what I'm going to give you, but I'm going to give you a special reward. I'll think of something. So backer 300. So I bet you no one's going to back until they hit 300, but 300, backer 300 will get something special. You know what? Let's do this. I'm going to give something special to the next three backers, right? Let's just do that.
Wait, three of them?
So right now we're three away from 300, Lily. All right? So we're at
297.
We're
all going to be executive
right
producers. No, I'm just kidding.
I can't offer that. Well, you know, I don't want to, like, just whore out the executive producer. It should be a special credit, you know?
Okay. It's all good, man. It's all good.
Hey, Lily, while I gotta do something quick here, can you what did you feel about the screening last night? Any special moments, highlights, personally that you know that you experienced? I know you said you saw some of, you know, you saw Quark and Wilsh, but anything else that maybe watching the movie?
If that person could like message on the YouTube, like there was like I was always hearing like one like particular person like laughing really hard, and I was always wondering who that person was. It was like. Like, everyone is laughing and everything, but then there
was... me! I was laughing hard.
That wasn't you, no. They were, like, sitting in the audience somewhere. His voice is a lot deeper than yours.
No, but when I laugh, it's high, so it's a high-pitched laugh.
It's like a ha-ha-ha. But then this person was, like, they had a really good laugh, and I was kind of, like... That's one of the highlights for me is, like, during those special parts of, like, Lumpia when, like, the funnier parts or, like, the sillier parts. And everyone's laughing, that's the part that I like walking into or like, you know, watching the audience. I'm not a creeper, but I'm just like, I just like, you know.
I'm the same way too, because especially this kind of theater. Not all theaters you're able to do that, but this theater in particular, mm-hmm. you're able to stand by the side and kind of see how people are reacting. You know,
that was a very special theater too. They had like love seats or whatever, couple seats in the back.
So who sat in the love seat? We should look at that picture, that theater photo. Who was on the top love seat? Oh, I know who it was. I know. Because I told them to sit up there. The couples I knew.
Couples were sitting together. I think, because Sean was there. Sean and David Dean was there.
Sean Kirkhoff, who plays the Love That Lumpia guy. My honorary Filipino friend there.
Yeah, that was also like, hey, it's good to see. I haven't seen him in a long time. That was cool.
Yeah, it's always nice to see Sean Kirkhoff. And if anyone there's actually a fan of Sean Kirkhoff's character, he does reprise his role in Lumpia 2. He has another scene. I promised him 5 more seconds, though. But he does have a line, but I'll stretch it up 5 more seconds for him.
So. Does he say, love that Lumpia Sariwa or something? Love that Turon.
Maybe we should make that a contest. What do you want Sean Kirkhoff to say in the Lumpia sequel?
Oh, shoot. So wait, the next three...
And maybe our new EP, Danny Rubio, can chime in here. Danny, what should Sean Kirkhoff say in Lumpia 2? You're the executive producer. Mr. Thriller from Sarah Manila, where you at? Sarah Manila!
Oh, man.
Yes. You know what? You know what? Like Pee-wee's Playhouse, that's going to be the key word tonight. Anytime we say Thriller from Sarah Manila, we're going to go... That means we're going to have to find excuses, some ways to always throw in. Thriller from Sarah Manila. All right. Okay, let's go back to the board here. 297. We still need 3 more backers here.
Hey, Patricia, I'm going to be right back. I got to, help these customers open.
Oh, customers, always in the way. Always business. Business is never... I don't really know what my phrase was. But if you're just joining us, welcome to the Lumpia Cast. I am Patricio, and it is Friday night, and I am begging for your pledges tonight. We are 3 away from 300. We're just 1,000. We're like almost not 1,000. What are we on? We're like, this is where my math skills don't really come through here. We are... 916 away from 50%. Wow. 50%. So I know backers 98, 299, and 300 are going to kick this off because we need some pledges. So who's going to push us over 50% here today? You know, so this weekend is a big day too. So let's do this, Lumpia lovers. Let me log on here, and what are we doing here? Nope. All right. Comments page here. I'm waiting for people to join me. So who's around here?
Hey, Pat. I do have someone that was at the screening yesterday also. Mm-hmm. This is Gail. Mm-hmm. She went to watch she went to watch it in LA. So
hey Gail, welcome to the Loopy Cast.
Hi.
Yay. So Gail. Can you hear me, Gail?
Yeah.
All right. So, wait, you were at the screening yesterday or in San Diego?
I was there yesterday.
You were yesterday?
Yeah.
And now you're in San Diego. That means you you traveled.
Well, no. Yeah, I traveled today.
Through car, train, plane, boat?
I drove. I go to school in L.A. and I drive out here.
Ah. So, what did you think about the screening last night?
Oh, that was the first, when Lily told, I've been seeing it on Instagram a lot, Lumpia and the Lumpia.
So it's working! All those Instagram Lumpia bombs are like, getting you all interested, right?
Yeah, I think that's really catchy, so I never really asked about it, and then Lily said, oh, I got these Lumpias screening in L.A., so you should come out. So I did, and brought a friend, and I was asking about it and then heard that it was like this homemade video and it was took like 7 years. I'm like, oh, that's interesting. I bet they're going to have like problems with continuity, but it's going to be really funny. But I really enjoyed it.
It's hard to explain that kind of a movie to someone, right? It's like everything that a movie shouldn't be. It has continuity errors. It's got to be homemade.
Yeah, but I think that's what like Lumpia... That's the essence of it, is that it was homemade and that it took too long, and the imperfections of it is what makes it charming.
Wow. Now, do you think that so with the Lumpia 2 now coming out, what are your, Lumpia 2, we're not planning to make it homemade and stuff. Yeah. Do you think, because it's not going to be homemade, that we're going to lose some of that charm?
I was thinking about that, mm-hmm. and it's like, I wonder how they're going to carry that spirit of really being in one's neighborhood.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah, I'm concerned about that.
Mm-hmm. If there's one thing that we should, if there's a character, is there something in Lumpia 1 that you want to see again in the sequel?
I'm thinking like if you can't raise enough funds or if the Kickstart doesn't go through, I think that maybe you should just make it with DSLR cameras or whatever camera you have on you, or an iPhone camera, with that same spirit of a homemade movie but with mm-hmm. today's technology.
Nice.
Yeah.
All our videos are always do it yourself kind of style, you know, whatever cameras. We'll keep it open. For me, I think what's interesting, what makes it interesting is for me to also grow as a filmmaker. I think it's time for me to take the next step. And I think, having it homemade and do it yourself, I don't know. I feel loopy. I feel that I haven't really made that action film that treatment deserves. And I think the charm of it, I don't think it will be lost if I am able to get everyone back together again. And
mm-hmm.
I mean, who wouldn't want to see Moon Moon see if he can act with other professional actors around him?
Mm-hmm.
I think that'd be cool. And for me, it's about the experience of making it. You know?
Yeah.
And I think there's a reason why we're doing it the Kickstarter way, because this is definitely not the kind of movie that you can that I would probably go to an investor or to a studio.
Yeah.
I think it's only right that since the movie was made community style, like it's just a bunch of dates, and it's coming. Well,
totally.
Let's open it up to everyone else. People like you who can come in, be a part of it, and just feel like they're part of something fun, So. Yeah. So was that your first time watching the film, Gail? Or,
yeah, that was my first time. I've seen the debut, but I haven't seen this movie.
So do you have do you mind asking what's your favorite part? What's the part today that you still remember that you just can't get out of your head?
Of the debut?
Like that? No, the Lumpia.
Of Lumpia. let me think. Every time that you would cut to Kelly's the shot of Kelly's eyes with the soft vignette around it, and then you would cue the music.
How it's even always. Though I live a
thousand.
So
that song's been stuck in my head.
I'm gonna make it stuck in your head even longer.
Yeah, it's really funny, but that was one moment that just I kind of woke up to this morning.
So you did hear when you woke up, you heard the song. Even
yeah.
though I and in the close up of your eyes.
Yeah, that's me. It was funny. I liked it a lot.
Well, Gail, thank you so much for coming out to the screening. I mean, that's pretty hardcore that you actually drove up. I mean, you know, coming back down again. So it's I don't know how to say it, but thank you, you know, for
yeah, thank you.
Coming out.
Good luck with it. Lily should be here soon. She's almost done.
Well, you know, again, remember, we only have 3 days left. Let's see if you being on here got us some pledges. We're still stuck at 297. Come on, Loopy lovers. We can do this. I want to hit 300 tonight. So what do you want to say to the Loopy lovers out there, Gail? Are you still Gail? Hello? Gail.
Yeah, I'm trying to hear what you're saying.
For anyone out there, why should they make a pledge right now? Just try to sell Loopia 2, the Kickstarter, to them. And Gail, I want you to sell it to them. So they're listening right now. There's viewers watching this right now.
Uh-huh. What should I say to them to donate money? Sorry. It's okay, love. Thank you. Have a good evening. I think you should donate to this because nothing like this has ever been made before, especially for the Philam community. And never heard of a Lumpia fighting superhero. And it's kind of fun to look up to a person like that.
Sweet.
Yeah.
Thank you, Gail. Well, hope to see you again, Gail, and hopefully see you at the premiere of Lumpia 2, because we're going to... We all believe we can do this. I mean, what more? I know we're like our backs to the wall, and you know it's the fourth quarter with 2 minutes left, and like we're down by, I don't know how many points. Well, we're definitely down by over $25,000. You know, I think at some point, you know, when you're on Sunday, we're gonna go for the Hail Mary, you know, and we're gonna see if we can.
Who do we
score.
Make friends with? Who can we make friends with right now that has $25,000?
Click one button.
Oh wow, there's like a lot of people like that posted. Did you see this?
I can't multitask. It's like my computer.
Ha ha.
Hold on. Why don't you read the comments? I'm gonna adjust my computer here so I can.
All right. Okay. So Quia, RJ, Fellow P710750 said, I just backed you up. Not against the wall, but somewhere. Andrew.
Wait, do we get a backer? Hold on.
Hold on, I think so. Go check. Oh, wait, I'm reading them backwards. Okay.
It's Friday night. I'm like, maybe I didn't refresh my screen.
Maybe you need a refreshment.
We got a backer!
Woohoo! Yeah! 298!
Here we go! Lupia Ball! 298! And I'm assuming it's Kuya, right, who did it? All right, here we go. The night has now begun.
He's been working the graveyard shifts. Thanks, Kuya RJ.
Awesome.
I'll tell you Kuya RJ forever.
So now we're on the Lumpia Bomb. I gotta admit that these Lumpia Bombs are, you know what?
There's a
you got to understand that these Loopy Bombs were made with love, handcrafted, and I got to say it's done by the Loopia crew. And so, you know, when I saw a lot of these Loopia Bomb Fist in the trash can over at Pistahan, that hurt it, man, you know.
I was making those last night, and I fell asleep. You know, after this screening.
And you know what?
What? Dude, your volume went down. Hold on. I can't hear you. Dude, your volume's gone. What happened to you? Ah, Patricio! Can you hear me?
What?
What?
Can't hear you.
What?
No, I'm not.
Yes, in the big group picture. Patricio is mute. He cannot speak. So Patricio is trying to say is, we hand make those, and we spend a lot of time putting them together. And it's not, we don't send it out to like a factory or whatever, some children to make it for us. We actually do it ourselves. So we have someone print out the lumpia, and then we actually glue the lumpia flyer to a stick just to make something fun for the community. So I have a couple people here that are donating right now. So if we see his name on the list, his name is Brandon. Woo! Woohoo! He missed his greeting last night, but he has seen lumpia before, haven't you? He has. Hey, Gail, can you do me a favor? There's like a lumpia bomb on where the Balik buying box is. Can you grab it for me, please?
Yeah.
So, Patricio is working on his sound. Right, Pat? I hope you can text me. But then, so... I was trying to make these last night and I fell asleep, but I made 12. It comes with a stick. It might give you, it's handy dandy, and you could like, when you're at Pista or FPAC, you could just wave some fresh air. So, Patricio, we got you now?
They're going to FPAC.
FPAC is this weekend. So, please, oh, it's dark in your house. Dang, dude. You better white balance that camera. No. Can you hear me? Choo-choo-choo. So, who's going to FPAC this weekend? Leave some comments on YouTube. We can give you a shout-out right now. And then tomorrow, you're going to get a lumpia bomb and just bomb the heck out of Long Beach. Put that lumpia bomb next to, like, I don't know, water, put it next to like that big bell that they have there near the park in San Pedro. Let's hope we got him. We get you, Pat? Speak. Say something. I can't hear you. What happened to you? But then I'm about to lumpia bomb again because I see someone right in front of
you. Can you hear me?
Yes.
Yes.
We can hear you.
Oh man!
I can see
so
you.
It's the same thing. So I'm on a lav mic so that it doesn't sound like echoey like this, and it basically my 9-volt died.
Oh no!
And the thing is, once I unplug it off this main camera over here, then
starts working again.
Basically. It gets frozen, and I can't turn that off because that's the main host. So we're gonna broadcast off this.
Blah here. Blah blah technology words. Blah
plus,
blah.
Plus it's HD. Okay, so what I was saying.
So are you gonna have like a camera on your sweatshop that's happening upstairs in your house right now?
Well, I'm waiting for someone upstairs to log in.
They should, so you could see like the hard work that your wife. And everyone is putting into, like, making those lumpia bombs so that you could take that lumpia bomb to, like, K-Town and bring it to the Jollibee and lumpia bomb Jollibee, right? Or you could lumpia bomb. Where else can they lumpia bomb? They can lumpia bomb, like, USC some more or UCLA.
Put it on a statue
somewhere.
Well, I mean, I don't know if anyone's actually done it yet, but if you actually check out the hashtag in the Instagram or Twitter or Facebook, there's a lot of interesting pictures there. I wish I had more time to show them, but so anyway, when you get a chance, just go to Instagram and look up hashtag LupiaBomb. A lot of creative. Photos, even pictures that I haven't seen, you know, and I just caught up. I saw some really interesting pictures. But I was saying that I don't know if you mentioned this, Lily, because I wasn't hearing you. But like, the first printing of these Lumpia Bomb fists that premiered during Comic-Con. Oh, they're, yeah. They're all gone already. So these are the authentic ones. So anything that says August, obviously, is not August anymore.
I have the old one.
Yes, that this is authentic. This is like limited edition. Maybe one day you can say, "Hey, kids, there was a time I had the first edition Lumpia Bomb."
Go check the Kickstarter. Go check the Kickstarter.
And some fool in Comic-Con just came up to me and gave me this.
See, but okay, check the Kickstarter because I have one more Kickstarter person that donated right now. What's the gift?
What is the gift?
He just. We were gonna do it for the next.
All right, slow today.
Oh, you're.
Oh, Lumpia Ball 99.
What's that bell? I thought it was a ka-ching. Ka-ching, ka-ching.
Probably Mr. Belvedere bell. That shows my age.
I made that donation. It's my roommate.
Where's my freaking reward? Where's? Oh, here goes. Lumpia Bomb! Thank you! What's your name? What's your name?
I'm Brandon.
Brandon! You got a Lumpia Bomb!
That's my roommate! Bam.
Damn. Hey, Brandon, before you leave and buy and with your food, tell the other Lumpia lovers out there who haven't pledged yet why they should do exactly what you did just now.
Because you're awesome.
Me? Thank you.
Well, that's a good reason.
He has cool stuff at his house.
He does. There's a comfortable nice. Bed.
Well, thank you for pledging a new backer for backing that lumpia.
Back it up.
Back it up.
Can't do it.
We're backing stuff up. Okay, well, he's going to get some prize because we're going to do up to 300, right?
I'm going to think of a prize. I haven't thought of a prize yet because I'm trying to think of what do I have that has three of.
He's going to want your Optimus Prime.
You cannot get my Rufio action figure, so I'm sorry. Everyone's been asking about the Rufio action figure. One of a kind.
Thank you.
Let's see. We are one away from 300. And hopefully by the time it hits 300, I can announce a prize for all three of these backers on a Friday night. But, you know, we're also 861 away from 50%.
Woohoo! What? Woohoo!
50%, you know. And you know what? It's going to be almost 2 days left. Nothing would please us more to hit 50% with 2 days left. That means we just need to make a quarter each of the days, next days.
I don't have enough friends, man. I used up all my friends already. I'm gonna text some more people tomorrow.
But you know what?
What?
Your friends are friends, no people. And it's not just one person we're trying to target. We're trying to target multiple. So if we were like 25,000 away, our goal should be to get 25,000 people to donate $1. Because it's all about the strength in numbers. By the way, the Lumpia Fist, I know we said this would be the limited edition, but we have a new one, and we are giving them away at FPAC this weekend.
What?
At Point Furman in San Pedro. So if you're going to be at the Festival of Philippine Arts and Culture, you got to come out to our booth. BucketY.com has teamed up with us, and they're going to be hosting our Lumpia 2 Kickstarter booth, and we're going to be giving away some free stuff. So imagine if you make a pledge, all current and new Kickstarter backers get a free movie poster. I know some of you already have it, but you're getting a free reward, and your car's not even charged yet. So, even though the Kickstarter it will be a success on Monday night, you're getting your reward ahead of time. So we're going to have DVDs, we're going to have shirts to give away, maybe some other exclusive stuff, but free movie posters. So if you're going to be an FPAC coming out, even a dollar pledge, you know, even though it hurts my pocket doing this, I will give you a free movie poster. And hopefully that will make you feel so bad that you'll donate at least $2.
Those posters are nice, man. That was a really nice design for the poster. I met the artist.
You gotta give props. to Gerald Pillar, man. Yeah. Gerald Pillar has drawn the Bigger the Con.
I met him and I didn't know what to say to him. I was like, it was a really great poster.
All right,
can I give props out to you, Andy? Andy says, with great times at the showing last night. Great job on everything. And he's proud of you, all you guys.
Thank you.
And then Andrew Andy said he loved the love seats. Andrew likes how I'm working right now. I'm at work and doing this. And Kuya RJ Fellow, he donated under his real name. And he backed us up.
This Lumpia is very peed up.
It's here. We got, how many, or are we in the double digits in the viewership or just like one digit? Because I see three people like posting. Toot, toot. But what's up, guys? How's Akuya and Andrew and Andy? What are you doing, Kat? Oh, Eric's in here again. Eric Tionko. No picture? Pat! I can't hear Pat again. Can anyone hear Pat? Is it just me, or can I just not hear Pat? I can't hear you, Pat. Pat, I can't hear you, man.
Hey, kill some time. I'm getting ready for our next guest. Sorry.
Why didn't you tell me before of like Pat's like.
Come on, sidekick! Come on, sidekick!
I'm trying. You have to tell me what's up, man. Who's the next guest? Can you tell us? Okay. So, Eric again. I see Eric every time we do this webcast. So hey, Eric, what's up, man? Always on. Let me see. I gotta say, we had a really good screening this weekend, or this Thursday. Actually, we ended up eating at Park's Finest Barbecue out in P-Town. So if anyone is in that area ever, if you're looking for a place with great barbecue, great Filipino food, and great bibingka cornbread, it was the shit. It ran out really fast, so definitely check it out. It's on Temple. I was super full. The brisket was really good. I forgot what it was, but it was in coconut milk, and that was good too. So, I see who our next guest is. Are we ready? I see who it is. So, please, 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 we need one more donation to make it 300. You could get your roommates to donate as well. Or your friends, and we're very optimistic. So, and definitely check out Bucket Wise booth in at FAC tomorrow, and also check out their website. It's very informative. I learn a lot of stuff from their website. They have really great writers on BucketWise.com. They're very up to date. Like they always have the new news going on in the community. And for community announcements or community events, definitely check out Bucket Y. It's not just only like LA or just only San Francisco, but it is, it's as many places as it can be. So just check it out. If anything, if you have an event to share or if you have a story to share, definitely send it their way and they'll be sure to have it on. Okay. Do we have another backer, Pat? I can't hear you, man. Do we get to 300? Come on, Pat. I can't hear you, man. You're talking in the air. Okay. So, remember again, tomorrow at FPAC, FPAC's all weekend. Check it out. Go there early because you're going to have to look for parking. I believe they have shuttles, but find Patricio, find Bucket Y booth, and check out their stuff. Get a Lumpia Bomb and bomb the heck out of that place. Just do hashtag Lumpia Bomb, and wherever you go at FPAC tomorrow, just take a picture like everyone else takes a picture. What? I can't hear Pat. Patricio, what's going on, man? Okay, I can't hear. So, anything else? Anyone else? Anyone ask us a question? I know this, the Lumpia webcast picture keeps popping up. Because we're trying to get some guests on, some special guests on tonight. So just sit tight, and hopefully they can get someone who's making these to just have a camera set up there, just to watch them work. It might be weird, but it'll be cool. It'll be like interesting. Come on, Patricio. What else do you want me to talk about? I am here at work. I'm at Filipino Food and Bakery. If you're in San Diego and you're up late and you need a place to eat, you need a silog, stop on by. We're at 2852 Main Street in San Diego. I don't know if anyone is from San Diego that's on right now on our YouTube, but check it out. There's food. There's going to be music later on, and I'm live webcasting here right now at work, so definitely check it out. Hi. Sure. You need a bag or a box or anything? Oh. Yeah, just earlier today. Yep. Pat. Pat's still on mute. So how's everyone doing tonight? Send us questions. Send us suggestions. If you still want to do what they were doing the other night with the Film Society guys, where they were taking shots for donations, let us know, because I will make sure that someone puts a drink in Pat's hand, and it has to be a shot of something. And if you make a $50 donation, you too can get Pat to get drunk before FPAC tomorrow. That'll be fun. All right, Patricio, get back on. Okay. So, I don't know if you can see him. He's actually on the phone. You got to get back on, Pat, right now. Right now. Okay. So, if you want Pat to take a shot, make a suggestion on the YouTube comments page. It'll be hilarious. And then he'll talk about Filipino history, and then we can have a drunk history moment with Patricio Janelsa talking about the history of Lumpia. That'd be dope. Let's do this. Let's do it right now. And I see AJ is about to hop on. So, AJ, are you drinking already too? No. AJ, can't hear you, man. Got it. That's how you usually talk.
That is.
You're actually...
How you doing?
Hey, how's it, man?
I'm good. Let's say hello to our viewers out there.
Hey, viewers. We got Kuya RJ. We got Eric. We have Andrew and Andy.
Oh, what's up, guys?
Night.
Yes.
I'm telling them to make a suggestion that Pat has to take shots again, But then he has to talk about the history of lumpia, so we could have like a drunk history.
Oh man.
And then you have to reenact it.
While he speaks it.
Yes.
Yeah. Nice. Nice.
I think I could get Will Ferrell to do it.
Yeah.
Yeah, we should do
cool.
it.
Cool.
And
cool,
Dante
cool.
Bosco. Dante Bosco and Will Ferrell.
Oh yeah, yeah. World of Wandog is asking us, please make Dante Bosco spam your Kickstarter. He has fans that will do anything for him. Well, I know we did the.
All the cosplayers.
Yeah, well, we did the geeking out with Dante Bosco, and he definitely put that out. Yes. So, you know.
Hey, tell us about the Lumpia Invitational, because like I just watched it and I was like, it was pretty hilarious.
Yeah, wasn't it? Wasn't it? Well, you know, it's something that me and John wanted to do, and just make it, you know, really about the food, and kind of do it in the style we wanted to do it, where it was kind of a documentary, but a bit of a, you know, sort of mockumentary style in a way, and make it feel like a TV show.
So the other chefs, they were okay with that?
Oh, yeah, yeah. No, they're down. Yeah, it was funny because we wanted to do... we were thinking to be like a very sort of poignant and traditional sort of... let's talk about our love for lumpia and why we ate it when we were kids and that kind of thing. But because of people like... The way it worked out, John Kasser, who was producing it with me, he had to kind of be a part of it. So we're like, you know what, that would be weird if you're competing, really, you know. But let's flip it and let's put you in costume and have fun, you know. So I think it turned out pretty well. It definitely.
The hair didn't look fake at all.
No. yeah. Exactly. So for those who watched the Lumpia Invitational. That was our buddy John Castro as Stash San Jose.
Yes.
But yeah, hopefully for those, have you guys?
But his deconstructed lumpia was kind of like I would have really. That was a very interesting idea, though. Like
yeah.
In like the cooking world, that would be like that's a great idea.
Yeah, but it was,
you just.
I mean, yeah.
And then you just like eat the filling.
Yeah.
I thought that was pretty innovative. Like.
Yeah. Yeah. Know. Yeah.
Those judges are haters.
Yeah. It was funny. It was funny. I mean, it was a little silly, you know. I mean, I don't know. I thought it was a lot of fun. I mean, and we had some great music in there from Beat Rock Music. Those beats were produced by Six Fingers, so had a lot of good music in there. And I don't know. Just felt it was a lot of fun to do. We shot that on the Red, also, which is
really?
Great. Yeah. So we had a Red and two 5Ds. Shout out to Armin and Romel and Gary. Thanks for helping me shoot that. Justin directed that. Madriaga. We definitely had a good crew on board. And in a way, I kind of wanted to do that as sort of a test pilot, you know. So once we were successful with this Kickstarter, when we are, come on, we can do it.
Yeah.
We can keep it. We can keep doing this, you know. So I was thinking maybe having another. Lumpia Invitational, Adobo
Edition.
So, like,
more challengers and stuff?
Oh, yeah. But I was thinking maybe we could just kind of keep Stash San Jose in all of the episodes. He's like the foil, you know, like, he's like the Washington Generals of that. So.
He's always like, for some reason, they have different competitors except for Stash San Jose.
Yeah, he keeps trying.
But they don't notice, because, like,
yeah.
Because he wears a different mustache or something?
Yeah. Yeah, no, no, no. It's just... It's kind of tongue-in-cheek. It's kind of tongue-in-cheek, so.
At least you guys had fun with it. I liked it a lot. I thought
cool.
It was hilarious.
I'm glad. I was hoping like it wouldn't be too different, you know, from the rest of the videos we've been doing, you know, but I think it's still very grounded in what it's about the food, and the font is the same, so I think, you know, that kind of kept people thinking, okay, this is part of that Lumpia campaign.
Okay. They're all connected.
Look at the font. I mean, it's obvious that it's part of it.
Yeah.
Hey, I just want to say what's up to Kuya RJ. What's Kuya up, man? Hey, thank you.
That guy's a hard worker.
He works
graveyard shifts, man.
Oh man, man, are you off now or are you working now, Kuya RJ? And Where are you again? What part of the country was it? The Midwest or? Yeah, let us know, man.
Yep.
So,
please let us know. Cool.
Lily, you're working too, right?
I'm at work right now, man. Like, I was helping customers while you were telling the story about the Lupi and the Sorry, I was really listening, though.
I was like, God, how rude.
Why she gotta, like, make sales right now? Hold up, puto boom boom.
Yeah, nice. You should have your customers get on the LumpyCast. And,
I did. I had one of my customers actually attended last night. But she's
oh, cool.
Like, she's just hanging.
Okay. Okay.
But she was able to talk about her experience because she never seen it before.
Oh, cool.
You have to talk about the true show.
Nice, nice. I want to see like a Lola or something, you know.
Yeah.
So, you know. Yeah,
I'll just have her come around to the back.
Yeah, exactly.
He wants to blow you kisses.
Yeah. Hi, Lola. Bless. Bless.
You put your head against the couch.
No, here you go. Bless, Lola.
And then she'll put her hand right here.
Yeah.
You're so
bless, sweet. Bless. So did you have fun last night at the screening? Really?
I did. It was cool. Yeah. Like, it was good. Like, I love hearing the audience laugh and mm-hmm. at the certain parts. And I love walking in during the karaoke scene.
Oh, yeah.
I was compelled to sing along with it.
Yeah.
And for the people to laugh, because they get mm-hmm. it.
Yeah. When they see the lyrics come up, they're like, okay.
I think you really, really get it when, like, you see the star wipe, and you're like,
yeah. yeah.
Star wipe.
Exactly. And you're just kind of appearing out of nowhere, you know, it's right. Sort of like, cut to, you know.
It was really dramatic before. It was like, dude, Monmon's, like, getting, like, he's changing. He's like, it's so weird. Like, wearing football jerseys and stuff.
He was.
He said, I. Like,
I know. All right, yeah, no, I'm saying.
Damn, we can't hang out with you pops no more. Okay. Then they do karaoke.
Like, oh, man, I know. That was one of the most genius act two to three breaks right
Is
there.
Because you guys, like, who came up with it? Like, was it, like, you or Pat? Or
I don't know.
You guys put your brains together.
No, I don't remember. I'm pretty sure Pat came up with it because I just kind of like, I don't know. I don't know what I did in this movie. I'm just kind of there.
You just threw your head up. You're like, oh, more
edit. Yeah. Yeah, God.
More work to do.
More stuff to do.
Why am I doing this shit?
Sheesh. No, but it was, it's fun. Definitely cool to see, you know, people enjoying it in a new way. Hey, I'm curious, can people see us or no?
No, I keep seeing if they can respond to us and let us know, because I keep seeing the live webcast sign on. They can
see us though,
because Kuya RJ said he has a day off, thank goodness, and he's in Chicago right now.
Okay. Ah, Chicago.
Chicago,
wait a second. So it's 12:30 over there?
Probably, yeah.
Oh,
is
man.
Is it 12:30, RJ?
Damn, it is. Yeah, we should know that. That's something.
Yeah. Good cool. idea. Good idea, world, like Jonathan or World of Wandag. Wandag.
Yeah. Oh, for sure. I mean, yeah,
I think. Well, if he put the signature Zuko on the bottom of it, on the bottom of the spam, like everyone would take. Like they're like.
Mm-hmm.
They would.
Yeah.
They're like, it's not a penis enlargement ad, so it's okay. From Zuko, it's cool.
Why, is there one that sounds like that?
I have no
penis
idea.
Penis enlarger. The pump.
I'm going to marathon right now. I'm marathoning work right now. So.
Oh, man. Well, yeah. So what's up with this 24-hour thing you're doing? And tell us the name of your store, where you're at, or your
restaurant. I totally already
restaurant.
Did. I hella plug. No.
Okay.
No. Well, 20 like on Friday and Saturday nights, because people are working late or they're coming from the gas lamp or from downtown. Like we stay open for 24 hours so they can grab something to eat on the way home, and it is a way for them to sober up, to get a silog, to kind of wind down from the night. So, and we get a lot of people working late. Like they work like graveyard or the night shift at the shipyard. So some of them. Some of them are in the military, so, hey, man, as long as we could feed them, we'll be here.
Yeah. Okay, cool. Well, you know, Lily, so we're getting some reaction here. Yeah, I know you can't view us, but
yeah.
It's like we're on the radio. You know, we got to hype it up. What's up with them Lakers? What's up with them Lakers? Come on. Come on, Lily. What's going on?
Screw them.
I know you're a Laker fan. Let's talk basketball. Let's talk sports.
Sports.
Come on. So, Mike D'Antoni, can he do it? Is he the right coach, or are we going to Phil Jackson back, huh? This is talk radio now.
Talk.
We got to step it up.
Talk radio. Okay, so we're going to throw these, like, hot dogs at this girl's ass right now, okay?
So, okay, do it.
My only talk radio is Howard Stern.
Oh, man.
So it's just like, that's my only...
Okay.
I listen to sports things, too, but then, like, Jay Moore has a show, right? He has a sports...
Yeah.
I listen to that.
He does.
Only when I'm riding with my brother.
Yeah. Well, there's Max and Marcellus in L.A., you know? Really cool. Yeah, cool dudes. Actually, one of the guys used to be a rapper, you know, so they have a... talk a lot of hip-hop.
Hip-to-the-hop?
Yeah, talk a lot of, you know, like... golden era stuff, you know, EPMD and you know, talking about Public Enemy and that kind of thing. So yeah, it's cool. All right, hold on. We're working on the picture, guys. Hold on.
Yeah. Well, Eric Ignacio is back. Eric, what's up, man?
Woohoo! What's up, Eric?
Okay, can we see if we got another donation through the Kickstarter, maybe?
Let's see.
I got my roommate to do it live on air.
300 backers.
Thank you.
Touchdown.
Yeah. Oh, is it a $10,000 donation?
It's not, but that's all right.
That's all right.
Thank you so much.
Ka-ching, ka-ching. We don't have the sound effects. I didn't do my...
Be here. I'm bringing up the sound effects.
Okay, can we get our IT department to work on this?
I know. All right, can they see us now? Oh, no, not yet.
Have you ever seen the show IT Crowd, though? That's a really good show.
I have not. That's with the guy with the big hair, right?
Yeah, it has Moss and the dude that was in Bridesmaids.
Okay. Yeah, I heard about that. That's on Netflix, right?
It is on Netflix. Oh, yeah, because I got Anna to watch it.
Oh, yeah.
I made her, like, she was, like, marathoning that stuff, so.
Yeah, she was.
You have got to watch. Oh, I see black. A black screen. Okay, that doesn't work.
Well, I see Pat down there.
Oh, I see. Oh,
here we go.
What did that
person say? Oh, I see. I see a thigh.
Whoa. I saw someone slide behind Pat.
I know. Hey, Pat. What kind of podcast is this?
I know. What is this horseshit?
Huh? Is that why we were blacked out? Huh? Is that why you had the graphic up?
What is this?
It's amateur like, oh,
color?
I'm gonna throw with a graphic. Stop. All right, sorry. That's Bastos.
That's a Bastos graphic, guys.
Bastos graphic. This is not how you look a bomb. That's not how you look a bomb. Sorry.
You only do that when we get a donation.
Oh, okay.
You show right now, man. Okay. Like, that is a $10 donation right there.
Lumpia Bob!
That's not paying attention.
I will stop. Who's watches? How many viewers do we have out there? Leave a comment.
I can't. Leave
some feedback here. We're drowning out of here. Come on.
What is this? What is this amateur hour?
Hey, Joy!
I did it!
It worked!
Yay, Joy!
Woo-hoo.
What's up, Joy?
Hello.
Oh, no. I see AJ showing his ding-ding.
How you doing?
You're showing your lumpias to the...
Hi! Hello!
Hey, sister!
Everyone, welcome Joy to the LumpiaCast! Finally! We got Joy Visco. But this is our surprise guest for tonight. Joy Visco in the house.
Joy, your webcam.
What's up?
What's going on? Look at that. I got on.
Nice. Are you is that from a flip phone you're broadcasting from? Is that your flip phone?
What?
iPad.
Ah.
Oh, look at everybody. Ooh.
So, you know what, we should, actually, you know what, Joy, why don't you, I'll have AJ interview you while I plug this. You're online right now.
Cool. Interview. So, Joy.
It's me.
Let's start from the beginning.
Once upon a time, I was Dell.
Bill Middle School.
Cool. Oh.
Hello.
You good? Yeah. Yes. How you doing, Joy?
Good. It's freaking hot in the valley, yo. Where
oh man. Ugh. I bet.
You're at.
I bet.
Not...
Yeah.
This is my hometown. Is it hot down there?
It is humid as heck, girl. It feels like the Philippines.
Oh god.
And you're like next to a fryer or something, right?
Always next to a fryer. And an oven that's working. Right.
Oven. Oh man. Oh man.
Okay.
Yeah.
You lose 10 pounds of like sweat.
Yeah. Oh. Yeah. Cool. So what you been up to, Joy? How you been?
Yeah, how's the baby? For the past 30 minutes trying to figure out how to operate this iPad with the loading and the I don't know wedding.
Yeah, it is crazy. It's okay. That's kind of customary with when we bring on guests. We go through like 15 minutes of tech support. But it's cool. People enjoy it.
Thanks.
So, well, good to see you.
Going live.
So things have been good? You've been,
baby! You know,
huh? Yeah. Ah!
What?
Sound effects.
Alright, so,
did you press that?
Wait, we have business to do, okay, so...
Oh.
I've been out. How many backers are we at right now?
300.
Oh, never mind, Loopy Bomb. 300. We're still
we only see the logo.
100 and
Lisa's on
821. $821 away from 50% of this Kickstarter funded, right? Did I do my math right?
Sometimes.
I don't know. You're a liberal arts major.
Joy, are you a math major?
Yeah, 800 is a lot. What,
Okay, we're only seeing the logo, Pat, so just FYI.
We're seeing the logo of what?
Oh, on the live cast, I can only see the logo. You can't see faces.
You know why? Because I have to.
Get the IT department back in there.
I have to mute that. There you go.
IT. Oh.
So, I need my loopy bomb. Someone stole my loopy bomb. Hold on.
I think it's the sweatshop upstairs that is working on it. Oh. No picture, dude. Just saying.
All right, 300, guys. After a week waiting, we finally made the elusive 300.
Congratulations.
All right. Woo! We need to get you a lumpia bomb, but if you have two lumpia, real lumpia sticks over there, you can actually just hold up two lumpia sticks.
Or your two.
On the fun.
Or your phone and a. Beer.
But,
Yay, Lumpia Mom!
Lumpia Mom! Lumpia Mom! Yes!
Lumpia there
Mom.
You go, two! Two!
Nice.
Are you doing, are you folding clothes now, Joy?
Buddy!
Mother, dude.
That's all good. Yeah, no, I should fold my pants.
You know, Joy, the ratings we have actually spiked up since you got on. I announced that the actress, debut actress Joy Bisco, has joined the Lumpia cast. So your ratings gold.
Can it be karaoke girl or is the karaoke?
So let's step out of this. So Joy, what do you want to say to the Lumpia lovers?
It is best with vanilla, vinegar, and garlic.
Mmm. And vanilla, too, actually. Chocolate. Mm. Whoa. What
sound is that?
That was the racist sound effect.
Yeah. Oh, man. Definitely.
Right now.
And the sweet and the sweet sauce too, right? The sweet and sour.
What?
Yes.
You know, that's what you know, 300. So I gotta announce a award for all three of these guys.
Just wanted to make sure.
But yeah, it's
pretty. I would hate to have had done like 500 of these and then like fall apart. You know what I mean? That would suck.
We bring in another guest. I hear another guest back there, AJ. Who's behind you?
Oh yeah. Okay. Here.
Your sound!
Oh, who is this?
All right, we're gonna call another guest.
Oh, another special guest? What? Another special guest? What is this? Friday night? No one else?
Am I talking?
What am I talking? Who am I talking to?
All right, everyone, welcome Gene Kahayan to the Lupi Cast.
What's up,
Gene? It's like a debut reunion here all of a sudden.
Yeah, I know. My God, I feel honored to be here.
And the ratings are skyrocketing even more now that you're online. Nice.
I just came over.
I just need the pledges to go skyrocket.
Can I get a
yes.
Little? So we have Gene Kahayan here. We have Joy Bisco here. And,
I came over to make these. I've made like 500 of these so far. And the next thing you know, I get dragged into the webcast.
Yeah. So here's the thing, you guys. You gotta understand that these lumpia bomb fists are handcrafted.
Handcrafted.
With love by Gene Kahayan. My wife, Melanie.
That's right, Mel and AJ.
I know Lily's done. How many did you do last night, Lily?
12.
So there's a special limited edition of 12 made by Lillian Priholis.
That's right.
Lumpia 2 producer. Now, it hurts me when I see these in the trash can. I'm talking to you, Pistahan. I see a lot of these thrown. You guys are using this as to fan yourself in the shade. Don't even bother reading it. And you throw it in the trash. So
what's that all about?
I know. Yeah, I know FPAC has more Lumpy love. They're going to represent this weekend because I know a lot of our Lumpy lovers are going to head out to our booth, sponsored by BucketY.com. They're going to pledge.
BucketY represents.
And they're going to get their free Lumpy movie poster.
Woo-hoo!
And you can pledge at least $1 for $1. And you know what?
What?
They don't even charge your card.
Not yet.
So it's like getting it for free. You're getting all this free stuff. All you have to
do is
get an F-Pack. You visit our booth. You say, love that lumpia. We'll give you a lumpia fist. You pledge, and we give you a movie poster. It's that simple. And then you can go to the food truck, and you can eat some real lumpia. And you can say hi to AJ. And Gene Kahayan will be in the house?
Yeah.
What about Joy Bisco? Joy Bisco, are you going to be in the house in F-Pack?
Today goes my birthday.
Oh. Yeah. Okay. But still, Joy is there in spirit, though.
Oh, snap. Okay, then.
Joy Bisco is always there in spirit.
Hey, you got to start taking shots, man. Take shots right now. Let's go. Let's
drink. God.
All right. So,
drunk lumpia history.
Wait. Our special guest is Joy because I don't, you know, Joy is has a connection to lumpia because she actually stars as the narrator. So she's the one who, her voiceover is the very first thing you hear after you hear AJ's the xylophone dad. So the fact you hear Joy's voice sets the mood for the entire movie. And once Joy's voice hits you, people are locked in. And they're locked in for the entire movie. How's that feel, Joy? You've set the tone for the entire movie.
It took me about like a whole year to prep for that. And I just wanted to give it the right amount of
Lumpia love, right? Lumpia love or lumpia grease? Which the right amount of?
Of a lumpia fist up yours.
Lumpia fist. Ah, nice.
Well, did you work on that Daily City accent or?
Yeah, hella.
Develop that.
I just wrote it on the script, so she had to say it.
She hella said hella like she was from the Bay though.
Right, she had to lose her 619 thing and do the whole.
She had to get out of the San Diego accent and get into.
Exactly.
That's work, man. That's work.
Hey, man.
That's research. Like that's like De Niro. That's like dropping like 20 pounds to play for a role or something like that. It's like awesome.
She's all hella. No.
Dedication. That's dedication.
You know what? I'm gonna announce right now that. The three people who pledged today, Packers number 298, 299, and 300, are going to get a free copy of not only the Lumpia CD soundtrack, the original one, but also the Lumpia 2 CD soundtrack when it's released once we get this Kickstarter campaign. So you guys will won two soundtracks, including the Lumpia 2 CD. Give a round of applause. And remember, none of this counts or exists unless our Kickstarter makes its goal by Monday night, 11:59 p.m. So I do want to reiterate that just because you pledge doesn't mean your job is over. Because, Gene, what do they have to do?
They got to spread the word.
Yes.
They got to spread the word. They got to post it up on their Facebook. They got to tweet. They got to Instagram. They got to do all that good stuff to make sure that the word keeps spreading.
Say it again, Joy. Said I didn't hear that, Joy. Sorry.
Oh no! I just said do that twatting, man.
Oh.
Twat.
Nice.
We're keeping it classy here tonight.
All class.
Miss you, Joy. I haven't seen you in forever.
Forever is a long time, Gene.
It's a very long time. It's a very long time. But you're a mom now. Look at that. Look at you folding the clothes in the kids' room. That's awesome.
Yes, I can't do it.
Jeannie, Lily, let's go to the comment board quick here. What's
comments. Quia RJ. Oh, okay, one, I don't know if I said this, but Lisa's on. She says, yay. And then Eric's back on. Kuya RJ is ecstatic for Joy.
And woo!
Kuya Bomb sent FedEx, and he wants it for his manager.
Do you have any questions for Joy or Gene? You guys, this is a rare chance to get the original debut people here. You have the director, the co-writer, the executive producer, Gene Kahayan, here, and you have Joy Bisco, the lead actress.
That's right.
Nice chance. Hit us your comments. What do you want us to ask them while we have here? Because we've got nothing else to do on a Friday night but just hang out here, Google style, in the Olympia cast. And we're here begging for your pledges. So ask us something.
Making Lumpia bombs.
Making them.
Quality work tonight.
I'm going to show a clip with Joy here, quick here. Let's see.
What are you talking about?
Is it a Star Wipe? Because the Star Wipes are awesome.
Star Wipes. I can't, that's a spoiler alert. You know, Joy being in the Olympia is.
Patricia?
Who is this girl again?
Something. What are those sounds, Pat?
Maybe something.
Melanie, remember? I was working over the booth at the Milky's Great Mall Theater?
Oh.
Classic. That's you, girl.
Oh, right. I remember you now. Melanie.
Yeah. So, I was driving here. Oh, here. Wait, so you're over here now?
Well, we're screening the debut at the Mall Theater, and I'm the lucky guy who's overseeing it all.
Lucky you. So, do you need any more people to work at the booth tonight?
Oh, I don't even know.
But since I already worked at Milpitas, you might know I have experience, you guys could use it.
You live in Fairfield?
I live in Fremont, but it's close by. And I'm already here.
What's the catch? No, I can't pay you.
No, I'll totally volunteer. So,
Alright.
Oh, that is so cute!
It's the only thing I have quick access to.
Yo, and Mel!
Where's so Melanie? Cute! So cute. I want to pinch everybody's cheeks right now. It was so cute.
Melanie will pinch your cheeks.
Oh, so cute. So cute.
Melanie's here. Here, say so hi, Mel.
Cute. So cute.
Say hi.
Hello. Hi to Joy, Mel. Hi, Joy. Oh, Mom.
Just welcome my wife, Melanie, to the webcast. It's fine. Time. Yeah. Bye, Jean.
All right, I'm busy. I got a lot of stuff to do.
Right. Okay. That's all you get. That's all you get of Mel. She's too busy. She's got more of these to make.
Yes.
She's cracking the whip.
So if you wanna get some lumpia fish with some love, you gotta go to FPAC and get one of these handcrafted lumpia bombs.
Get them.
Handmade.
Bucket why?
Handmade, man, right here.
Because if you go right now to Twitter or Instagram or Facebook and just click on the hashtag lumpia bomb hyperlink, you'll get all these crazy pictures that some of our lumpia lovers are doing. And
lumpia fisted!
Heck yeah.
Joy one. Joy, so how does it feel? Is this your first live webcast?
It's your first live webcast.
Talking to people in a really long time, can you tell?
It's Rainy's gold, though. I mean, you guys should be here every night, but that's just... It's, you're getting the viewership, but you guys are not necessarily giving us the pledges. We're stuck at 300 still. You guys, come on, you guys are friends. We're here. We only have 3 days left to go here. We can't do this forever. So, you know, if you have a friend or buddy who hasn't yet pledged and really wants us to make us sweat for this until the last second, you know, do us a favor. Pledge right now. And you will get Gene and Joy to give you a lumpia bomb right here.
That's right. A lumpia bomb just for you. Just for being 301.
Oh, yes. Well, and we'll answer the questions if someone donates.
Is there a question? Is there a question in the comment board?
Questions. There's one that asks, well, this person donated already, but if someone else donates, will Joy make a cameo in Lumpia 2?
Like, cameo, like, ow. Is that cameo?
Wah. I don't know. Should I announce this now? Me and Joy hasn't really negotiated yet.
301. We gotta wait for 301. That's what I'm saying.
I will announce, and I don't want to put Joy in the spot, though. All right, well, before I announce this, though, Lumpia lovers, do you want to see Joy Bisco return in Lumpia 2?
Woo!
Let us know first.
Woo-hoo!
You want us, I mean, if we get the response right now, if I get...
Like me!
If I get backer 301...
Give me the damn...
In order to, okay, here we go. In order for Joy...
Joy, we want Joy!
In order for Joy to get into Lumpia 2, we need to get backer 301 right here. If we hit $25,000 tonight, we will get Joy Bisco in Lumpia 2 for you guys. But it has to be before the end of the telecast. So, come on, backers. I know there's someone out there. Team up. Let's hit $25,000. Let's hit the 50% funding goal before we take our last stand at FPAC tomorrow morning.
Dude.
You want to see Joy Bisco in Lumpia 2? Let us know.
I want to see Joy Bisco in Lumpia 2.
Oh, I pressed the wrong sound effect. Sorry.
Yes. When I live 5 seconds away from the border, man.
Yeah, I know, exactly.
The case, that's cool. Two, we accept that.
Wait, are you down in San Diego right now, Joy?
No, I'm in my child's room.
Ah, yes, that's what I was thinking.
I'm in the valley, but no, I'm heading down to San Diego tonight.
You are?
Yes. Birthday. Shout out, moms. I know you're not online or whatever, but she turns 70 tomorrow.
Oh, wow, 70. That's a big milestone. Congrats. That's awesome.
Ooh. Good times.
Very, very cool. How old is your child now, Joy?
I just had a kid, like, 25 months ago.
So 2 years. Oh, so it's a terrible twos.
Yeah, man, it's so terrible. Like, he's a different kid. It's crazy, right? They change. Like, they
very
change.
Quickly.
It's like 2 months, 3 months ago, he was like a totally different kid than the way he is now. Like, he doesn't listen to his own person. Everything by myself. Like, chill, dude. It's okay. I can help you.
That never stops. It's always it's going to keep going that way. Mine are 13 and 15, and it's like it's a new adventure every time.
Bingo, Gene.
Congratulations. That's awesome.
Ask me what my kid's name is.
What's your kid's name, Joy?
Oh.
Okay.
Go. Oh.
You look great, by the way.
Oh, you're just saying that because it's only my kid.
So I have a question here, Gene and Joy. So I know a lot of people here are watching. We're here for Lumpia 2, but are we ever going to see a debut 2?
I would like to.
Ooh.
I would like to. So, you and I, Pat and I have worked on screenplay stuff as well as John Castro. We have kicked it around quite a bit, you know.
Are you going to make an announcement tonight? I'm prepping. I want to know. Is it going to be a big announcement tonight, Eugene?
Not to be too serious tonight, but as you and I have spoken about many times, Pat, I'm looking at the experience that you're going through with Lumpia 2 and the Kickstarter craziness that you're going through right now and trying to look at that as a barometer for what we can plan for debut 2. So
the guinea pig. Lumpia 2 is basically the guinea pig for debut 2. Thank you so much.
Honestly, in many ways it is. In many ways it is, because I'm going to learn from what you guys accomplish, right? You know, and then of course you will of course be integrally involved in debut 2 if that ever happens. And so the more successful Lumpia 2 is, the more likely debut 2 is to happen.
Oh,
Garcia's more expensive now, man.
Yep.
No, and Gene, I'm curious, though, what if the debut one was actually shot today? How different would it be? Have you thought? I'm sure you thought about that.
Oh, yeah. It would have cost a lot less, because we would have shot on digital as opposed to film. I think we would have made the story a little bit more intimate. We wouldn't have had such large sets, and we would have concentrated more on the characters. But the basic story, I think, would have still been the same. You know, we would have had cell phones and Facebook and Twitter as opposed to beepers.
But you would still cast Joy Bisco today, right? I mean,
of course I would cast Joy Bisco.
Okay, all right.
And you know Joy's got a huge role in debut 2 if that ever comes to pass.
Don't act surprised, Joy. Don't act surprised.
I just totally lost that. You cast me as an 18-year-old. I love you, Gene.
Yeah, totally.
Debut
now. No, but if debut 2 comes to pass, we will only do it if we get all the main characters back for the sequel. It makes sense only if we get all the main characters back, which I hope we can do.
Hey, Lele, anything on the comment page over there?
Yes, let me go through it. Our EP is talking to us apparently. Okay, let me see. Danny Rubio wants to know about the missing live audio track from the debut DVD. Pat, AJ.
What is it? What was the question? Is that an AJ question?
It's you and AJ. It's there's a missing live audience track from the debut DVD.
Oh.
Damn! What happened to that? That's a Pat question.
Did I tweet about this? So
that
basically.
Is a Pat question.
Okay, so Danny, you're getting
we're working with Sony. I had recorded audio from the Puente Hills screening of the debut.
Puente. That's right, 626.
And what happened was that we had synchronized it, and it was basically this was supposed to be the first time while you're watching the movie, because you've seen the director's commentary, you've seen, like, you know, all the other stuff, subtitles, but we've never seen, like, the, like, how does it feel if you're actually in the theater and watching the debut? Because it's not the, you know, I mean, it's a different experience when you're watching a debut with a huge crowd, right, AJ?
Yes.
And so we submitted it to Sony. It didn't get approved in time because we didn't sync it up to the actual movie. That what I didn't realize was that recording it in the theater doesn't necessarily mean it's going to match up to the DVD version of the debut in terms of frame rate.
Frame rate, it's like 29.97 compared to you know, a drop frame, and then when you go over to you know, a DVD, you're going at 23.8 non-drop frame. It's so obvious.
Also,
like, come on, man.
Dude, Joy fell asleep, guys.
But to answer the question, yeah, it didn't make it to that one, but I learned my lesson from the debut, and I put that on the Lumpia DVD. And this is before it became popular. I think, who's the first one? What's that Tom Green movie?
I think Freddy Got Fingered?
Freddy Got Fingered, I think it was that one. They did the whole live DVD.
Freddy Got Fingered? That is an obscure reference right there, man. That's like a Dennis Miller obscure reference right there.
I do want to give a shout-out to Chris Abbott. He said, PG, calling you out, Pat. And happy birthday to Lisa. Always leaves us.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday, Lisa.
Happy birthday. Should we sing a song?
No, let's sing a song. Where are we singing a song? Here we go.
We're going to sing?
Happy
birthday to you. Happy birthday
to you.
God, we suck.
Happy birthday,
dear Lisa.
Happy birthday.
I'm gonna hide. To you.
Hey, we're all delirious right now.
Seriously delirious, man.
Alright, did I get a pledge? Oh, we're still stuck at 300.
Not yet. No one.
Maybe because it's 300, this is Sparta.
You hit 300, we're still stuck at, we still need $821.
Hey, someone wants to know all of your all's opinions on the reboot of RoboCop.
Oh my god, I just saw the trailer there like a couple of hours ago.
What?
Why fuck with the original? Seriously.
Well, you didn't like the trailer? I heard the trailer's cool. I haven't seen it yet. I heard the trailer's pretty good.
You know, there's no need for a remake for RoboCop. Remake something else. Not RoboCop. That is like sacred ground for me. The first RoboCop was a very first violent R-rated film. Oh, no, that was Beverly Hills Cop.
That was a classic movie, man. That was an.
I saw La Bamba and RoboCop back to back on the same day. I don't remember.
Those are very different movies. Yes.
But after watching RoboCop and seeing all that violence and nudity, La Bamba was a good chaser.
It's a palate cleanser.
Now, did you sneak in, or was it like a back-to-back doubleheader movie? What?
Dollar movie.
You snuck
actually,
in.
Actually, took me. I don't remember.
What?
I was working in a movie theater. That was my very first, well, actually, my second job as a teenager. I was working at a movie theater, and we were playing La Bamba and RoboCop.
What are you looking for?
So I saw each one of those movies dozens of times each. Crazy.
Oh, that was your palate cleanser. It was just one or the other.
Exactly.
The Bobo was so snappy, I had to watch something violent.
I don't like the RoboCop trailer. Have you guys all seen it?
You don't like it? I heard it was pretty good, but it didn't do anything for
like
you.
It's like a normal Hollywood film. I mean,
Isn't it the guy who directed 28 Weeks Later?
I don't care who directed it. They're still fucking up with RoboCop. I'm sure it's going to look creative. It's going to be like Total Recall. Like that's another movie I don't know why.
Yeah, that was disappointing.
Anyway. I mean, how would you feel if someone remade the debut?
Oh, reboot.
As long as there was a good paycheck in it. I think we'd all be happy if there's a good paycheck in that.
We're still stuck at 300. Joy, anything you want to say to the Loopy lovers? What can you tell them to pledge? There are people watching, obviously. They're just
if you pledge free show. $10 right now, Patricio's going to take off his shirt for you.
Oh,
man. But then if you add another 30,
no.
He's going to give him a massage.
Yes, someone pledges $10 for me to take off my shirt, and once I take off my shirt, we lose $1,000.
PG is still going blind.
The whole goal is to go forward, not backwards.
They'll take back their money.
Refund.
No.
You know, we did get a, I think out of this whole experience, usually people like cancel their pledges and they increase their pledges. But we had actually one backer. I won't name that backer because I don't know who it is. We just hit 301!
Yay!
Take off your shirt!
You have to take off my shirt?
No. Take off your shirt! Take off your shirt.
Oh, no, the shirt police is here. The shirt police is here.
Take it off. Take it off. Take it off, baby. Work it. Shake that moneymaker. Shake that moneymaker.
Oh.
I have never.
AJ, don't take it off, AJ. Don't take it off,
twerk it. Twerk it. Twerk it.
Not my reward. No, AJ, not the fist.
Twerk it like Miley Cyrus, baby. Twerk that shit.
No. Oh, God.
That fist isn't holding up two fingers.
I was small. Please.
Come on. Your shoulders, Pat. Show your shoulders. No one's ever seen them before.
No.
I've never seen that.
Oh, Petite is Pat. We need some shoulder.
What?
We need some shoulder, Pat. Come on, keep teasing.
You can't be faking that shit, man.
For $10, I don't want to lose $1,000. I'm scared.
Do it.
Your price is higher than $10.
Really come on. $10. You got this $10.
What's the price? What's the price? Is it 50? Is it 50 or is it 100? What's the price?
I just want to hit 25,000. Someone that has
$800.
$801. We only gained.
Come on, Pat, show us your shoulders. Come on, let's go.
Oh.
And then, and for another $40, AJ will massage you.
No. Oh, AJ. Oh, AJ.
You got it. $10, man.
I want to know what's going on underneath the frame right now. Jeez, what's going on down there? I see fisting happening. I see some. There's all kinds of innuendo going on over there right now.
It was a show.
That's Pinoy love right there, man.
Rio 2 gets us a back rub. Come on. Pat, why are you sitting so low in your chair? That doesn't count, man.
That's Pat's he got.
I wanted to see your shoulders bare. Come on, man, let's do it.
Oh, just the keys on. He was the one who put the $10. I'll go to your house and freaking take off your shirt.
Look at you two guys. Look at you. All we're seeing over here is the tops of
just
two heads.
Just the keys on, the pervert. And you know what? While we're plugging Justin Keys on the pervert, he's gonna be on the next episode of Geeking Out While Eating Lumpia with myself and Will Spartaccio coming out this weekend. Not tomorrow, Justin Keys on, because you freaking gave $10 to see me shirtless. Justin Keys on. He's an agent of what's his blog name? Agent of Guard.
AJ.
We're at 301, Patricio.
Yeah.
301. We're 301.
Yay.
Pinoy Draco donated $3. Come on. Do it real quick. Just flash him. Flash him real quick. Come on.
Flash him.
We want to see
my farmer's tan.
Sure.
Look at
that farmer's
tan right there.
Oh!
Look at all the heat. Justin, you like that, Justin? You like that, Justin? How about the other side? Want to see that? Look at that. Look at that farmer's tan.
Hot stuff.
Oh, look at that. Oh, ebony and ivory right there.
I had no idea.
Have you been working out
that? Oh, my God, I'm being fisted.
Oh, man.
This is how we follow up the National Food Society.
This is the only way we can follow up Patrick and Steven. By not drinking, but stripping.
Dude, drinking really helped, man. It really did.
We're drinking up here. We're drinking while we're making Olympia bombs right here. We're totally drinking. We got wine. We got beer.
Someone has to hand Pat a shot of something. Then he'll really take off his shirt.
Yeah.
For real, for real.
Yeah, and you'll get that for free.
That's $10. Dude, I don't want to make Kid Pinoy Draco, like, mad. We need to fulfill this, like, promise anyway.
Oh, that's messed up, Patricio.
Oh, I keep pressing the wrong sound effect.
Yeah, what is that sound?
What's that? Oh, shoot. AJ's leaving me here so we can go to the liquor store. Oh, snap.
You know what? AJ's leaving
to go get booze. Uh-oh.
It's Friday night, you guys. We're just getting started here. I don't think we're going to end by midnight. So, you know, tell your friends. We're still online right now. Tweet about this. Send the link out. Tell the network that we have debut Gene Kahayan and Joy Bisco. And we got Lily Perholis.
Yeah, Joy.
We got AJ Colomai.
That doesn't matter to me. Yeah.
Hey, Lisa, requesting shoulder.
Dude, I will do anything if we hit 25,000 right now. 25,000.
Anything.
Well,
you had to do.
Consensusly.
Dude. You are so lucky.
You just got AJ to his knees. You brought AJ to his knees. What the hell?
There's AJ.
Okay, if yeah. we have Melanie to take
what do I do with...
would you do it?
I gotta put him back in the closet, hold on.
You're back in the closet? We got an R. Kelly song happening over here.
And you can get your own AJ as part of a reward incentive, because he will show you his lumpia.
No
way. Reward. I thought I was joking.
Prove it.
All right, so Justin Key's on. Justin, I am calling
you
out.
It's all Justin's
right
fault. It's all Justin's fault.
Adjust your pledge.
Right now.
Give us $100, and AJ and myself will show you some skin.
Whoa. Okay. Justin pledged $10 to see your naked body, man.
Pat's not that inexpensive, man. He's high class. It's $100 for the two of them. It's $100 for two.
Well, if you're a Thriller from Sarah Manila tonight, Thriller from Sarah Manila. That's our secret. That's our secret word today. Thriller from Sarah Manila.
Thriller,
Sarah Manila. All right. Justin is quiet right now.
Justin's in shock.
I know. Justin, you got the hang of Will Spartaccio. It's all good.
You were under the freaking desk the whole time, dog.
What?
You were under the desk the whole time. We saw nothing.
Yeah. There was
Joe, are you going to get on this too?
And
if you guys want to see Joy show some skin...
You're
gonna give us $1,000 right now. Because we gotta hit 25,000. That was a big surprise for Joy Bisco. Hit 25,000. I was gonna announce that Joy Bisco is gonna strip in Olympia 2.
Wow!
What?
Where'd that come from?
Strip Lumpia, come on!
PG in your ratings, PG.
Joy Bisco. I want.
I thought this was supposed to be family rated, man.
We're doing what we can right now.
Racist scene. Shit.
We're working this, Mr. G.
There we go. That's what I mean. All right, who's out there? Come on. Comment board, Lily. Come on. Let's get
some
here
Let me double check. The last one I got was from Justin, so.
Justin, if you're there.
Oh, he's wondering why he's getting called out, dude.
Justin,
And Lisa wants to know, did Pat ever work in Serramonte? Pat, did you ever work in Serramonte?
No, my brother did. The reason why we shot Lumpia in that shoe store is because he worked there. It used to be called Wild Pear.
No kidding.
Yes. my brother used to work at Suncoast, too. So part of my job every summer was to drop him off or pick him up at Serramonte. And I would always hang out. You know, when you close, the best place to go in a mall when it's closing is Miss Fields Cookies because they have all the cookies for sale.
That's right. Yeah. That's so they're clearing it out.
So that was my summer of, like, going to Miss Fields Cookies, grabbing the discount, and then picking my brother.
You have doubt, basically.
Yeah.
hey, so is Serramonte still like the cool mall, or has it become the other mall over the years?
Well, it got cooler.
It got cooler to the point where when people watch Lumpia, they keep asking me, dude, I remember the water fountain. It's all like feng shui now, and like, I don't know.
Oh, no kidding. So is Lumpia 2 going to be shot in Serramonte? Little spoiler alert?
You know, now that we have the mayors, not a lot of people know this, but the mayor of Daly City and the vice mayor of Daly City was at the Daly City screening on August 9th. They loved the movie, though. Wow. I was scared because I thought they were going to make a list of all the violations I did with all the non-permits of all the stuff I'd shot in Lumpia 1. And of course, I cringe when they showed the urination scene. I was like, oh, maybe that's going to get me in jail. But they loved it. I mean, they stayed to the very end.
That's cool.
Shout out to Mayor Ray. But they said that when Lumpia 2 is funded, we can shoot in City Hall. So now I'm writing a scene that takes place in City Hall.
Sweet.
So this is an announcement, actually. This is an announcement. So the announcement is we're going to have a scene that takes place in City Hall, and it's going to somehow start the vice mayor. So the vice mayor is going to want a part in it. So vice mayor, I know you want a part in it. You're going to be in Lumpia 2 because we're going to create a scene in City Hall. So maybe when we get Lumpia 2 funded, the backers can tell us exactly what happens in the City Hall scene. So what happens in the City Hall scene? Is it perhaps a corrupted politician who's maybe working with the underground and maybe he's trying to protect the mayor?
No!
Or maybe Kuya actually works for the mayor's office.
What?
Or maybe Zeus is a bodyguard protecting the mayor and then Kuya has to come out of nowhere and save the mayor. Or this. Next to Lumpia 2.
I gotta help
Superior some guys. City Hall Day.
You're in.
She peaced out?
I think she had to go pee.
Oh, okay. I thought she didn't like my City Hall scene. Alright, so Lumpia lovers, you heard that. So where should we, for Lumpia 2, now that I have this City Hall scene from the Daly City, I remember, Daly City, I'm calling you out, all right? So when Lumpia 2 gets funded, because I believe it's going to get funded Monday night.
Yes.
First thing I'm going to do is going to go into the city, Daly City office, and I'm going to get all my free permits.
Yeah. Call them out. Call them out. Get government to work for you for a change. That's right.
No more homemade guerrilla-style film. We're living the life now. And it goes back to the original question: are we going to shoot Serramonte, aka Sarah Manila?
Yeah.
Yes, I want to. But if I don't get it, I'll just shoot it in Westlake. And if not Westlake, maybe I'll shoot at top of the hill. But not top of the hill. There's always 10 for N. So either way, there's a mall scene there in Lumpia 2.
Ah, well, do you think you could sneak in and do it like guerrilla style if you didn't get permits for Serramonte?
I think everyone knows who I am now. I'm not the same kid with a camcorder walking around.
Oh, man, so your celebrity's working against you? You're too big for your own britches now. That's a bummer, man.
Daly City. Wait, where are we at now? Let's see, backers. Gene, while we're taking this break, I want you to plead to the Loopy Lovers in your debut tour, 2002 voice, speech-wise, before each screening, why it's important to back that Lumpia. And go.
And go. All right. Look, it's the same thing it's always been. I mean, this has been an issue for our community, not just our community, but all minority communities who don't get enough representation in movies and TV, right? We always sit around, we complain. Hey, we got a new visitor. All right, cool. We always sit around, we complain about how we don't see enough Filipinos, we don't see enough black folks, we don't see enough Latin folks, we don't see enough this, we don't see enough that. But in the age of the internet, which is where we're living right now, there is no excuse anymore. So if you want to see more images, you want to see more stories about us, you want to see more lovely actresses like Joy Bisco and talented directors like Patricio Janelsa and amazing filmmakers like AJ Calame and all of the other folks who are making Lumpia 2, put forth $10, $20, $50, $100, whatever you can afford. Even if it's a dollar, it doesn't matter. It does not matter. Every little bit counts. And what you're doing with that money is you're helping to empower your community. So this is actually a very important thing. In all seriousness, we're goofing around, we're having fun, and we're trying to get Pat to show us his sexy body and stuff. But in reality, you guys, seriously, I've known Pat since he was an intern on the debut, back when he was still a film student at USC. And look where he is now. He's directed some of the most amazing Asian American and mainstream music videos of the last 10 years, right? He has grown as a filmmaker by leaps and bounds. Leaps and bounds he has grown as a filmmaker. And now he is about to embark on what he considers to be his first feature film, but in many ways I don't think of it that way. I think it's just a natural progression for him as a filmmaker. And that's the reason why I donated. I'm supporting. It's the reason why on a Friday night I'm here making Lumpia bombs, because I believe in what Pat will be doing with this film, and I hope that you guys will too. And we need more support.
And then the way we always end these speeches is don't forget to check out our merchandise booth after the screening.
That's right. Although, luckily for you, these are free.
Yes.
Just go to FPAC tomorrow and pick yours up.
So, Joy, does that make you want to get a Lumpia bomb? Does it make you want to drive up to FPAC this weekend and grab a Lumpia bomb?
It really does, man. FPAC always falls on my mom's birthday.
Oh, that's right.
How come I haven't been able to make it? Like,
we should move FPAC another weekend, or move your mom's birthday.
Mom's birthday.
Or have your mom's birthday at FPAC.
Yeah, exactly. There you go. Have it all come together.
That's right. You've got the trippiest sound effects.
That's Google, man. Not me. Oh, we have a guest here. Who's the guest over here in Filipino Food and Bakery in San Diego? Introduce yourself.
Oh, I'm AJ. I am Lily's roommate.
AJ, welcome AJ to the Lumpia Cast.
I'm just speaking over my Lumpia customers real quick.
AJ,
I'm your next actor.
He'll take
actor.
Up his shirt.
Your next actor.
We always need more actors. But what's your audition for us? What makes you qualified to be in Lumpia 2?
I have no qualifications.
Oh, you're in! You're casting him in Lumpia 2, guys! AJ is going to be in Lumpia 2. Look at that. Look how easy it is to be in our film. There you go. Lumpia 2, starring AJ. He's going to be dude walking in the background behind Moon Moon. With a Lumpia bomb! Eating two fists in Lumpia. There we go. We got your part already. AJ.
Yes.
What are you doing on a Friday night?
What am I doing tonight?
On a Friday night, yes, tonight.
I just got off of work, and now I'm going to eat some sea lobes.
Okay. Do you have any wisdom, any words of wisdom for our Lumpia lovers?
Actually, I do not. Sorry to say, but I've never seen the show.
Oh!
Ah!
Dang.
No, we still love you, AJ. You're still going to be in Olympia, too.
He lived all the way in Temecula. So he didn't have access to the movie at all.
No.
Temecula.
Yeah.
Well, this is like that one of the attendees at the screening yesterday who admitted she watched it illegally. There's ways to watch Lumpia. But you got to understand, even the illegal downloads of Lumpia, the movie right now that you can get online, that's all the old version. It's none of that remastered shit that everyone saw in the theater in 5.1 audio, remastered. You actually hear Joy's voice clearer now. It's separated and nicely remixed by Ryan Frias.
That's right. So, 5.1.
Ryan, give you props, Ryan. Gene, do you agree? I mean, compared to the original world premiere from San Francisco 10 years ago, you got to admit that this print was... Oh, wait, you were even there. You weren't there.
I've seen bits and pieces. It's pretty amazing how you guys sweetened it up.
Yeah.
Pretty amazing stuff. The wonders of technology. It's amazing how good Video 8 can look.
Yeah, and you know what? All the people who were there in the theater last night can actually now put it on their bucket list that they saw a Video 8 shot film on
That's
the
right.
TV, and it looked fucking amazing.
That's right. The true home movie, man.
AJ, do you remember what Video 8 was?
What, Vera Wang?
Video 8.
Vera Wang?
Yeah, Vera Wang. Do you remember who
Vera Wang? Vera Wang? What?
Like...
No, I
Video 8, Vera Wang? Video 8.
No. Okay. Video 8. Do you remember the format Video 8?
No.
See, it's a new generation. What's the oldest?
That was my very first video camera was a Video 8 video camera when I was like in high school or something like that.
It's not even high 8. That's not even digital 8.
Yeah, exactly. It's before high 8, right? That's not old even school. Not even. Yeah. Not even.
I just made it look hip again. Video 8 hip. There's gonna be all these YouTube hipsters now shooting all the YouTube videos on Video 8.
So what's the synopsis of Lumpia?
Maybe this is a good test because since you haven't seen part one, and I'm trying to make Lumpia 2 a very standalone film. All right, am I ready for this pitch, Gene? I don't know. I'm not good at pitching, Gene. I got to sell it to AJ, man. I got to get him excited because
exactly,
I want to...
Exactly, elevator. Like, what if you get caught in an elevator with Steven Spielberg? You got to be able to pitch it just like that. Boom, boom, boom. Oh. Your elevator pitch. And go.
All right, so... this takes place 15 years of the original. This is about a silent Avenger named Kuya who has to return to his hometown of Fogtown to prevent an escalating drug war between Filipino factions. But in the middle of all this, caught is two residents who have to team up with Kuya and have to stop this drug war, but he has other things to do, goes in the wedding. Oh man, I fucked up the wedding. But it all ends in a lovely wedding. It's an action comedy. Think Machete with no nudity and not as much violence.
I'm out. Sorry. That's good.
I knew I should have hired more import car models in this movie.
Yeah, you need to put that stripper scene back in, man.
I'm not gonna fall for that trap.
No. Male and female strippers, both equal opportunity situation happening right there.
Hey. I don't like where this conversation is going.
So.
Drinks for you yet?
What was that, Joey?
AJ back with those drinks for you yet?
AJ's making Lumpia bombs. He decided to be good.
Yay!
Since we have to be up early in the morning for FPAC, so.
Oh, right.
We're still stuck at 301 backers. AJ and Joy, I'm really counting on you, especially Eugene, to force us to 302 backers right now. Because our viewership has spiked because AJ doesn't know that he's also ratings gold here.
Ratings gold, AJ.
How do you think that's such a fan base, AJ? You have a big fan base.
I'm sorry, what was that? I'm sorry.
You have such a big fan base. The viewership just went up ever since you got online.
AJ, you have this shirt when the next... backer comes on and pledges.
Yes. I have to take off my shirt?
Yes. Because Joy Bisco said so. Oh. That's even... That's... That's like, you know, Simon Says, but when Joy Bisco says, that's a must.
Okay. What you said? When the next bagger comes joins?
Yeah.
I don't even know what that is. I don't know what I'm doing.
The next backer.
Okay.
Oh, backer. New one, backers.
Backer.
Nothing.
I'm. You know what? I'm holding up the Lumpia bomb. You guys don't deserve a Lumpia bomb yet. You don't even have 3-1 yet. Or 3-2.
No Lumpia bomb yet. Oh, so we should put down the Lumpia bombs?
Yeah, no, because that's only if we get the backers.
We need to go. Okay, Lumpia bomb only with the backers. Okay, bye bye Lumpia bomb.
No, I'm like.
Any questions? AJ, can you read the comment board there? Are you able to read the comment board?
Have a good evening.
15 years after the original, the Lumpia armed Avenger reappear.
No, not that one.
Oh. That was my pitch.
Oh.
Your pitch is up on the comment board?
I don't know.
Eric, you have to read these.
Which one?
Eric said it got awkward fast.
Eric said it got awkward fast. Then Danny J. Rubio said, get the backers to 26,000 and Joy Bisco is a go.
And then,
what does that mean?
And you remember Danny Rubio is our Thrilla from Sarah Manila.
Sweet.
All right, which means he's executive producer now of Lumpia 2. So we have now even more clout. So when he says we have to get the 26K and Joy Bisco is a go, it has to be a go. Because he is a Thrilla from Sarah Manila. So let's get us a 26K. That's a pretty daunting but very possible goal tonight.
Is it?
So we gotta think of what can we do to will that. We gotta come on, put your thinking caps on.
24.
Come on, yeah. Folks.
So 3-1.
Even if it's $1.
Lost Joy Bisco.
Even if it's $1. A $1 donation.
Remember, yeah, it's faith in numbers. You take $1.
My kids donated.
Because you know, like RoboCop, the original, I'll buy that for $1. Will the new movie have that line?
It makes you wonder if all the great catchphrases from the first one. That was one of the most memorable things about the first one was all those great catchphrases.
I'll buy that for $1.
I'll buy that for $1, exactly. The Tigers are playing tonight. Classic stuff.
And Joy, well, what do you have over there? Are you,
You said to put my cap on. I wasn't
cap
sure.
On. Okay, good. Okay, so here we go. Now we're going to get some ideas here now.
Which cap is this?
This is the angry. My son is obsessed with Angry Birds.
Ooh. It's an Angry Birds hat? Oh, look at that.
All right, so Joy Bisco has now put on cap number one. If you want to see cap number two, give us a pledge right now. Maybe we can get her to wear both hats at the same time.
Did you know that female mosquitoes are the only ones that bite?
Holy shit.
Is that really?
Joke, it's a fact.
It's a fact. And you got that for free. If you want to hear more fun facts like that, pledge right now.
That was a very worthy Snapple cap fact, right?
And you got
there.
That
I
for
never
free.
Knew that. I know, right?
But that's crazy, right? I was really intrigued by that, and then I told that to one of my buddies, and he starts laughing, and he's just like, oh, of course that makes sense, and it totally went over my head. And he's just like, bloodsucker, get it?
Yeah, that kind of makes sense. That's so wrong, though, man. So wrong. So wrong.
All right, so, you know, remember I said if we hit 25,000, I was going to make an announcement about Joy Bisco's involvement with the debut, too.
What?
Really?
What's going on right now?
We're just when you thought you were out, Joy, we pull you back in.
Oh, woo!
Oh, we got another cap. Come on.
Another cap. You got hats galore over there. Hats a go-go over there, man.
Is AJ, are we going to do a drink? We got to do some shots. I'm in a mood for some shots now. We're gonna have to start doing the drinking game.
Pat's calling for shots.
It's just stalling.
AJ's looking for booze. Oh, yeah, there you go.
If anything, what the National Film Society taught us is that we need to do more drinking telethons.
Oh, that's true. That's true. I'm seeing AJ pulling out the shot glasses, right? Oh, my gosh. Seriously?
Tangerine.
Really?
Hey.
Oh, snap. I gotta drive home tonight, man. Come on.
All right, so here we go. This is our first thing. We're
I'm totally kidding.
Shot
I'll
right
do a shot. I don't
shot
care.
If you get $50, we're going to start at $50, right? If we get a $50 pledge or a $50 increase into your current pledge, we will take a shot right now.
Boom.
We're going to start small. $50. Come on.
$50 for a
increase
shot.
Increase your pledge $50 or a new pledge for $50. We take that first shot. Joy, can you join us or no? Or just me and Gene right now? AJ, can you take the shot with us?
Come on, AJ.
What do they have there, the Filipino food and bakery in San Diego?
Come on, Joy.
They could get me something.
I could get him something. Just give me a minute. I gotta do holo.
Joy, maybe you have an apple juice or something.
Yeah, Joy, you can do like a an apple juice shot.
Hey, I'll do a bamboo shot.
All right, so here's what we're waiting for: a $50 pledge, and you can either, if you're really pleasuring and you're watching this, you just want to increase it by $50.
Sweet.
We'll take a shot right there. That's what it looks like. Right. I'll have my glass soon, but, you know, $50. Increase it or create a new pledge, $50. We're starting out small. New shots. I'm sure the first one's going to knock me out already.
These are Jaeger bombs, too, man. Look at this, man. Yeah. I haven't had a Jaeger shot since, God, I don't know how long.
Here's the thing. How long do you want us to hold on to these? No.
Mel's drinking wine. She's a happy camper right now.
How long do you want us to hold on to these shot glasses? And here's my servant over here. My servant.
Woo! My servant AJ!
How much longer do you want us
you
to hold on to these shots?
You just got AJ. Joy, you missed AJ.
$50. I don't know what you guys are talking about. But I'm just telling you. Focus here, guys. Focus, all right? $50 right now. Increase your pledge. You take the shot. So there's going to be two kinds of bombs. This, two kinds of bombs. Jaeger bombs and the Lumpia bomb. All right.
Jaeger and Lumpia bomb. I want to see AJ shirtless again, man. That was hot.
Gene, I don't know what you're talking about. What are you talking about?
That was a whole lot of sexy, AJ.
What?
Shirtless? You're crazy.
Gene.
Are you wearing your glasses?
Dude,
it's too much. No. Is that a Joy Bisco request?
Hey, AJ, nice to meet you. My name's AJ, too.
AJ? AJ, what does AJ stand for you?
AJ stands for Anthony Germain.
Oh, no way, oh. Mate. Anthony Germain. No. Arthur James.
Arthur James. Joy, you.
The jam.
Apple jam, yes.
Joy, you left at the wrong time, Joy. You missed AJ shirtless.
No!
You totally missed it.
I think Gene's hallucinating. I don't know.
I don't know what's going on with Gene, dude. I think he's seeing the debut too, the wrong movie here.
Yeah, I got my shirt on now, Gene.
Did we get the pledge yet? Come on. Hey, you guys, come on. We're not kidding in here.
No, we lost Joy. What happened? There she is.
I'm holding on to this Jaeger bomb here, and it's not...
They should have two.
Our EP wants you to make a donation of $200 and watch Joy dance. Are you agreeing to that, Joy? Someone's saying if they make a $200 donation, Joy will dance.
Joy will dance. Do the running man.
She'll dance.
Okay.
Running man.
The spot too.
No, I'll do the RoboCop. Joy's got to do the RoboCop. Keeping with the theme
guys,
of the evening.
What else do you want us to do here? We still got 3-1 backers still.
I really want to do this shot. Come on, somebody step up. I want to do this shot. I'm feeling like drinking this right now.
We got our viewership just spiked, so there are people out there definitely who are waiting.
What is that, Joy? What is that, Joy?
Is it?
Did you get something? $50.
We're looking at $50 over here. $50.
Come on.
$50. Increase your pledge or make a new pledge right now. We will drink this. If you make a 200 one, Joy will drink it while dancing, and Gene will do the RoboCop.
How do you do the RoboCop again? Someone's gonna have to teach me how to. I'll totally do it. You have to teach me how. Mel, can you teach me how?
I'll buy that.
Mel's gonna teach me how to do the RoboCop. Mel's gonna teach me how to do the RoboCop. It'll be awesome. It'll be totally awesome.
$50.
Somebody step up. $50. I want to drink this. I want to drink this.
Guys, leaving us hanging.
Who's going to do the...
I'm about to put my shot glass down.
AJ Kellerman has to twerk, dude. You have to twerk, man.
Twerk. AJ's got to twerk shirtless.
I don't know. Why do you keep saying shirtless? What is it about AJ going shirtless? How much would you pledge to see AJ shirtless? Comment right now.
We already saw AJ shirtless. We want to see him again.
No, what is it?
Both AJ.
Joy, did you see AJ shirtless?
Both AJ.
No.
Joy, did you see that?
This turned into chaos.
Lily, did you see AJ shirtless?
Which AJ?
This one.
Either AJ.
No, the other AJ. Editor AJ.
I think that I...
Arthur James. Arthur James AJ.
Arthur Apple to Jam.
All I need is glasses.
And I'll finally see both AJ shirtless.
We're still looking for increase here. Hold on.
All right, back to report. How we doing?
Checking. Justin Keyson, where are you? You wanted to see me shirtless. Now you've disappeared? Come on, increase that pledge, $50, we'll take a shot, you'll see Joy dance, well, he gave us $200, and you'll see at least Gene do the RoboCop.
How did that go again?
AJ hasn't drank yet, and he's already...
Wasn't it like this?
Wasn't it like this?
The RoboCop?
Don't let you do that.
How do you do the RoboCop? I totally forgot how to do that. So it was some sort of something or other thing.
All right, so if you guys are joining us now, because we're getting even more viewers now joining in, we're waiting for the... Oh, wait. Someone, Eric, wants to go cha-cha lessons from Joy for $500.
Oh!
Wait, Eric, you're going to pay that, man?
Are you going to pay for that right now? Wait, hold on.
It's totally $500. Yeah, we can do cha-cha over Google.
Is it in the dollar amount? Let's see.
Let's increase it, dude. Increase it.
Increase it. Eric, if you want to see that, increase it by $500.
Or from AJ with no shirt. Arthur James with no shirt on.
Because for $500, not only will see Joy dance, she'll give you cha-cha lessons, you'll see Gene do the RoboCop, you'll see us take our shots. I think that's money.
I want to know, how much does it cost to see AJ twerk with a shirt off? I want to see him twerk. That's what I want to see.
The other AJ, right?
No, Arthur James AJ. Arthur James AJ twerking with a shirt off. That's what I want to see.
$1 million.
$1 million. Okay.
Demonstrate it right now. Show us how it's gonna look, Arthur James.
Mel's showing me a video on how to RoboCop, so I'm trying to learn how to do the RoboCop dance. She pulled it up on YouTube. It's the wonders of the internet.
This is what the Kickstarter's campaign is all about. It's about teaching people.
How to do the happy feet dance. Look at this. You can learn all the freaking cool dances here, man. This is cool.
No, that's not that cool.
All right, guys. So all the viewers out there, we have double-digit viewers right now. You guys are watching. We're giving you a free show. $50 we're asking. Up your... Oh, it spiked again. So if you're joining us right now...
Is it like this?
AJ will tell you what needs to be done.
I'm learning. I'm learning right now as we are...
You need to...
I don't remember that being the RoboCop.
No.
Okay.
This guy has got a different interpretation of this video.
Shot, it's like my arm is slowly pulling it down.
Oh, no one wants to drink this.
No one wants to drink. You just want us to talk again.
That doesn't look like the RoboCop. Is that it? What is this?
I think I'm having fun just seeing Gene learn.
Mel's teaching me the RoboCop right now.
If you're just joining us now, we're waiting for a $50 pledge
now. Mel's teaching me the RoboCop.
Let's just start drinking this already.
We can take our Jaeger shot.
Let's just take the shot, you guys. Come on. Ready, Pat? AJ?
No, hold on. Let's make that plea.
Not for
Come
free.
Come on.
Yeah, not for free.
Somebody put some money up. I want to take this shot.
So thirsty.
I'm itching.
Last time I drank.
Mel's getting ready too. Mel's got her glass of wine. This is Mel's glass of wine right here too.
Need
Everybody's gonna be drinking.
Need what?
You know what? I'm gonna post it. I'm gonna tweet this because I want people to give us $50 shots.
$50 shots.
That's like Vegas bottle service shot price.
Exactly. No, seriously. It's like we're some hot model at the club. It's like, you want to talk to me, you got to buy me a $50 shot.
Is this legal to write on tweet? Can we tweet by drinking?
Is that legal?
Yeah.
Is this legal? All
right, what should I write? We're live. Joy Bisco and Jinka Hai will take shots for $50. That's like a normal. Someone's right now at the bar drinking, reading this. What? $50? Fuck this shit.
I'm totally learning the RoboCop, guys. I'm so proud of myself.
$50 cha cha lesson.
Or something.
Basically, we're gonna. Yeah, I'm gonna put $50 myself in right now.
Come on, Pat, just put $50. We wanna drink it.
Back that lumpia, Gene. Back that lumpia.
I'm doing the RoboCop. Mel's teaching me the RoboCop right now, man. Look at this.
RoboCop, that was
from my... It's this. That does not look like the RoboCop to me. What is that?
Oh, my goodness.
This is the RoboCop.
Do the RoboCop. Well, how do you do the RoboCop?
Like one in one. But another one later.
All right, I wrote Joe Biscuit and Gene Kahane $50 pledge shots right now.
Right now.
Right now. Joy, how do you do the RoboCop? Because I don't think this video that Mel is showing me is correct. How do you do the RoboCop?
Well, I remember the RoboCop was... But it was like a... And then you go side to side. So
yeah, like, exactly.
Yeah.
It was more like robotic movements and stuff. This video that we're seeing online right now is more just like some sort of like jazz dance kind of a thing.
My, I love that.
That's a Mel.
Something like that.
We are all loopy right now, waiting for somebody to put up some money so they can do a shot.
That's how I'm going to act if we take this shot. This is like pre-game right now.
I am so about to drink this just anyway.
No, Gene, don't do it! No, you guys.
Okay. Put it away.
Give $50, we'll make Gene stop drinking.
Don't let me fall off the wagon.
Don't do it,
Gene. How is AJ in both places at once?
I know. He's like Clark Kent Superman. He's like just like flying back and forth. He's flying back and forth between multiple locations, man.
You're back, Joy. AJ's going to show up behind you.
You guys watching this, we're waiting for a $50 pledge. $50 pledge. What can we give a $50 pledge here?
50 bucks so I can do the RoboCop.
$50 pledge, and we're going to take a shot.
Just do it already, man. We're kind of excited. Oh, my God. Did he just take off his shirt?
Yeah. Dude.
There's AJ.
What are you talking about?
AJ.
Is Justin Keys on back there again?
Sexy AJ. Like
Justin.
Why doesn't Justin show up on like the Google Hangout, man?
What, Justin? I'm gonna invite you right now. We're gonna get to the bottom of this because if Justin Keys on gets on right now, we'll take a shot.
Justin.
Justin.
A Doc 415 is back. Yes. He wants to see.
So we're waiting for a $50 pledge right now, and so we're waiting for a $50 pledge so we can take our Jaeger shots.
Yes.
It's pretty warm. It's warm already.
It's pretty hot. It's like soup. Soup. Oh. I'll take a shot of soup.
All right, anyone out there, takers, we need a $50 pledge right now.
Oh,
Should we sweeten the pot a little bit? What else can we do here?
Our standards are going down. Just so we can drink.
Oh, all right, come on. $20. Oh. People want $20 now. $20.
Drinking.
$20, come on. Drink for my previous class just as much. And back once in a while.
We're totally whoring ourselves out for $20.
$20. You know what I can buy for $20?
We're so torn. So bad.
What did you drink for ADAC right there?
Yeah, you know what?
Okay.
ADAC 415, we will drink for you, my friend.
Yes.
Because of your previous pledge. So, yes. For ADAC 415.
Thank you.
Thank you for your drinking. Being
a hacker.
Thank you. Come on, Mel. Join us.
Cheers.
Cheers. Mel's cheers. Joining us for our that drink.
Yay. Yay.
Woo. Yay! Yay! Drinking. 1, 2, 3. Oh my god.
All right, and now, the RoboCop. And now the RoboCop.
Oh.
By who? Who's doing it?
I thought Gene was doing it. Hold on.
Do it, Gene.
How do we do the RoboCop?
Hold on, Gene. We gotta do this right, Gene. Hold on, Gene.
Isn't it supposed to be right?
Hold on, Gene. Where is it, dude?
ADAC. Thank you.
Yeah, dude.
Thanks for your previous pledge.
Oh, it's not, huh? It's an old school, huh?
I need a lesson in the RoboCop, Joy. Can you show me how? Then I'll do it.
Okay, if someone does... See, I'm...
Oh, we got drum and bass. Drum and bass, that's classic. Joy, give me a lesson. How do we do this? How do we do the RoboCop? Because I think that video that Mel showed me is incorrect. It didn't look like the RoboCop to me.
Any dance that AC Slater did all through Saved by the Bell was probably a RoboCop.
Yeah? How do you do that? Someone show me, please, and I'll do it. And I'll attempt it. Anyone?
Angeline! Is there a dance called the RoboCop? Or a song? Song that's called RoboCop.
There is. What are we looking at?
I don't know, I'm forgetting what Pat's looking at.
Who's dancing? It's a song, right?
Yeah, there you go. But what's the move? I can't see it. It's just white. It's just all white.
Just the big bright light.
You're gonna have to show me, Joy.
The demo it, girl.
You're gonna have to show me so I can copy you.
Someone do a Lumbia Bomba. Lumbia Bomba from ADAC 415.
That's like one step. That's like balancing on a tightrope.
Crazy.
Okay, there's my RoboCop for you right there. Woo!
It looks like either the Humpty Dance or the Ed Lover Dance.
Either that or I'm just completely...
Is that the Ed Lover Dance, man?
It's either that or I'm having a seizure or something. I need my meds! Somebody give me my meds! Okay, it's the gif of the day. Who's gonna make a gif out of this? Okay, there's my RoboCop! Woo!
Woo! Battle Joy at RoboCopping.
I'm out of breath.
Yeah, well, the Mew movie have that song, or a song that was inspired by the original movie. Come on, man.
You're going to do the RoboCop in your movie, Pat? Really? Are you
I'm just saying the new RoboCop trailer, I mean, that song was inspired by the original RoboCop movie. And what will this, what song will be, come out when this new RoboCop movie comes out? Was it going to be by Justin Bieber?
Yuck. Justin Bieber and Miley Cyrus together.
I hope they come up with one. That would be actually kind of cool. I wonder what the 2013 version of that would be.
No,
wait, when's it coming out? Is it coming out this year or next year?
February 2014, if I remember.
Oh, next year, huh? All right. RoboCop. Whatever happened to Paul Verhoeven? That's the question right there.
He was a five-hit wonder.
Five-hit wonder. That's a pretty good wonder right there. I wouldn't mind that.
Especially Showgirls is one of them.
Showgirls, yes. I saw that the other day on cable. It was playing on cable. I forgot how fantastic that movie is, man. That just, it's so entertaining. Such an entertaining movie.
Cable, you don't see the vaginas.
actually, this one was uncut, full-on NC-17. I think it was like, I don't know, one of the pay TV channels, like Stars or something like that. Yeah, but it was, I was watching it going, wow! Wow! So bad it's good.
All right, so Jack415 says Lumpia Boomba. I don't know what kind of Lumpia Boomba you want.
What's a Lumpia Boomba?
Drank.
Triple X, dude. That's not a 2. It's a triple X.
Or maybe I'm saying it right. Lumpia Bamba. Maybe it's like La Bamba, but Lumpia Bamba.
I would like to see what that looks like.
Maybe
Lumpia Bamba?
Bamba.
That sounds Bamba. Like actual name of a character in Bomba movies.
La Bamba?
Like Lumpia Bamba.
Boomba.
Lumpia Bamba.
Oompa Boomba.
Hey, that's a good porn name, dude.
That's a porn name. Doc415, gotta pick
total.
That one.
Lumpia Pinoy porn name,
you know,
right there. Lumpia Bomba.
For one of the packages is that you get to name one of the new Lumpia characters any name. I always wondered why they actually wanted to name them Boomba. Would I have to like cut it out or not?
Why? Would you cut it
what?
Out?
No, I'm just saying. I mean they earned it, right? The naming rights for Lumpia character.
That's true. Hmm. That is true.
So we are waiting for the next pledge here. It's already midnight. Usually we could be out in 4 minutes, but it's not worth us staying on if we're not going to get any pledges. And so we still got to wake up for FPAC tomorrow for the last stand. So
it's about to get a lot more fun. Let's just hang in there, dude.
I got a question for you, Pat. What movies are the biggest influences on Lumpia and Lumpia 2?
That's very easy.
Shot
for Lumpia
Smarter. Boo.
For Lumpia 1, it's definitely El Mariachi, Robert Rodriguez.
Nice.
Me and my brother saw that film. It was homemade. We thought, okay, they did a Mexican version of that. And there's what would be the Filipino version of El Mariachi? And so Lumpia. The best we could think of Lumpia. Was basically a guy in a barong Tagalog throwing a Lumpia around. I don't know.
That's awesome.
My brother thought of that, and I took it, and he was just joking around, and I actually took it seriously and made a story about it. So, thank you, Gar, for messing around. And
that is great. That is great. How about Lumpia 2? What's the big other
Lumpia
than RoboCop?
Lumpia 2.
Other
it's really
than
based on more of a graphic novel, The Dark Knight Returns, Frank Miller.
So oh, really?
This would be kind of a maybe not in tone, maybe Dark Knight Returns, but it is taking more of a comic book angle to it, but we're still keeping the story between Moon Moon and Tyrone. So it has seen the elements is the first one, but definitely Kuya's storyline in it has more of a Batman, James Bondish kind of tone to it, whereas Moon Moon is like the romantic comedy angle. And Tyrone's storyline is more like the, what's the movie? I can't really, where he, but anyway, the whole movie ends in, all the storylines converge in a wedding, and I already revealed this. So, whereas the first movie converged on a garage party, where all the storylines came back to a garage party, in part two, everything comes together in a wedding. Now, whose wedding is that? In the picture video, you saw Kelly wearing a wedding dress.
What?
Well, obviously, maybe Kelly's getting married, but who to who? Is it Moon Moon? Is it someone else? Is it, maybe it could be the karaoke queen's wedding that Joy Bisco plays?
What?
Joy Bisco's all over the place. That'll teach you for showing up on a that'll teach you for showing up on a YouTube cast on a Friday night.
Joy
gets every second of a Joy Bisco appearance in a webcast, so we're milking it.
I know, right? That's classic.
How often do we get this?
If you have a karaoke clip, I
don't you dare him, girl. Don't you bring it up. He'll pull that stuff up really fast. Get a donation?
No. I just like to say I'm playing that. We're still stuck at 3-1. Unfortunately, you know, I'm gonna give it another 10 minutes. If we don't get another pledge, we're gonna wrap this up because we're running way past our 12 o'clock midnight. As you know, this weekend, it's the last stand for us. All right, we're gonna take it at F-Type.
That's right.
We're gonna be there this weekend at the Bucket Wide booth. Still have no idea how it's gonna turn out in this heat in the next 2 days. But we're gonna do it for you guys because it is our last stand. We're still down $25,000 and 811 dollars short. $50,000.
It's going to be a hell of a weekend.
So, yeah, it is, I believe we can do this.
How many people to show up at FPAC? Do you know?
Thank you, bro. Take care, bro.
How many people in FPAC? That's a good question. How many people do you think show up at FPAC nowadays, Gene?
It's got to be... I don't know. Do you think grand total for the weekend? It's got to be over 10,000.
Mm-hmm. Boom! $2 each person.
$2 each.
Oh yeah, baby. That's right.
You know what? Dude. With your admission too. I forgot how much is admission to FPAC. Does anyone know?
Admission is, I think, $9 at the door.
For FPAC? Wow.
I believe, yeah. I think it's $9 at the door.
Joy. All right.
We have a comment here. Hi, Ate Joy. It's your cousin Vince.
Vince needs to donate.
All right. So here's the question. Hey, Joy, what you asked your cousin Vince, has he backed that lumpia yet?
Vincent, you got a big lumpia. Have you backed it up yet?
Because he can pledge right now just $1 and we'll stay on.
He's got a
longer.
Big lumpia. Now we all know that Joy's cousin Vincent has a big lumpia. That's good to know.
All the ladies.
So, Cousin Vince,
right.
Cousin Vince, listen up. You're obviously new here. You're out there, Joyce, here. We need your help. Please back that lumpia. Go to lovethatlumpia.com right now. Click the pledge button and just give us $1. Give me $5, $10. But if you give us $50, we will drink another Jaeger shot.
Yeah.
$50.
Let's do it.
$100.
Let's do it.
And Gene will cha-cha. And Joy will teach him how to cha-cha.
That's right. Gene and Joy are going to cha-cha.
Joy's going to teach Gene through the webcast thingy and walk him, or talk him through it.
Yeah, because I'm Filipino, so I can cha-cha, right? Because Joy can teach me.
So, Joy, once you convince Cousin Vince here, do you think he'd be down to back that lumpia? I don't know him.
Not for $50. job, Vincent? He ain't got no job right now.
He ain't got no job.
$1, Vince.
See, he'd back it up. He'd back it up, man.
$1 in the house. That'll be at least $10.
Pat has to halfway take off his shirt again.
Well, at Deck 415 wants me wants someone to do some moves from the Showgirls, maybe.
What?
Now, Showgirls.
At Deck 415, doing some moves from Showgirls, does that mean you will increase your pledge?
AJ!
So, we will consider doing a move from Showgirls. We'll pull up a YouTube clip and we'll
I think that's Arthur James territory right there.
Yeah, yeah. So,
Showgirls,
you know,
move?
We'll get AJ to mimic a showgirl.
Yeah, that's
clip.
Showgirls, baby.
So, at DAC415,
twerk it, baby, twerk it.
Challenging you to increase your pledge. $50.
Sugar and...
And another challenge, Cousin Vince. I know you don't have a job. Just follow, man. You can borrow it from your mom.
$1.
$1. Anyone from the Bisco clan, come on, just donate $1. Is he a Bisco? Sorry, I'm assuming he's a Bisco.
His mom's a Bisco.
Oh, okay, so Vince is a Bisco. He's in the Bisco clan. So from the Bisco clan, $1. Come on, Vince. Is there anyone there around you in bar $1? Because as RoboCop says, I'll buy that for $1.
Thanks, Scott. You're a nerd.
All right.
Bazinga.
So we have two challenges out there. Attack 415, Showgirls. Oh. Anime. Vince says, haha, wow, I'll back it up. What does that mean? Did he back it up?
I'm going to back it up into a cute girl. Or guy.
Oh, he didn't back it up.
Come on, we're going to wait for you, Vince.
Now, when you say you're going to back it up, does that mean you're physically backing it up the car or backing up that lumpia? Okay.
Thank you. Put $1, Vincent. Go hit up one of your friends to pledge another $1 and another $1.
You can surprise us. You can surprise us and just give us $11. $11 will bring us to $24,200. That's a round number.
Oh, I know.
$11. $12. Going once. Going twice. Showgirls. $50. Back it up.
Please. Showgirls. Who doesn't want to see that? Who doesn't want to see Showgirls? Come on now.
Wow, we're gonna have to work really hard for these pledges now. It was easier with the National Film Society. They just came boom, 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 and now like. All right, here it goes. We got 12-1 Studio says he doesn't drink, but he'll increase his pledge for a 16-ounce coffee chug from anyone.
A 16-ounce coffee chug?
From anyone. 16-ounce. Do we have a 16-ounce coffee chug? I think I drank all the coffee. 12-1 Studios.
You got decaf for me? I'll chug the 16-ounce.
Damn, we
got
to brew some coffee fast.
Vince has said, back up that lumpia. Does that mean he's done it? Let's see. Refreshing. Still stuck at 301. Are you teasing us?
Come on, Vince.
You're supposed to be back that lumpia, not tease that lumpia.
So raw.
So wrong. What else did we do wrong today, tonight?
Hey, I'm curious, what did that National Film Society do?
Oh, you didn't watch... I can't do it justice by telling you what happened. You have to see it. It's...
I gotta watch that.
You didn't watch it? It's
watch that for pointers, man.
I can't even watch it anymore. It was crazy. There were times when there were pledges happening once in a while, and then the $1,000 pledge came. We all cheered, and then the pledge went down back to 100.
Oh!
And then all of a sudden, Patrick goes, "I'll take off my shirt," and then the pledge went back to 1,000. It was like, whoa! It was crazy.
So we basically hoard ourselves out. Awesome.
Yeah.
Patricio, take
it. You're cutting out, Joey. What'd you say?
Take it off. The more
back that.
I take off my shirt.
Thank you.
She wants me to take off my shirt. But I just want Vince to make a pledge. You're still stuck at 301, Vince.
Come on, cuz.
I'm gonna make the Bisco clan look bad here.
Joey is a
guest
pledge,
here.
Homie.
We haven't seen her for a long time.
That's right.
And you're going to...
She's been a mom.
Stain that Bisco name. Okay, he says, $50 for each Joy Bisco Lumpia Bomb. This is from our Thriller from Sarah Manila. That's our magic word. Thriller from Sarah Manila. So Thriller from Sarah Manila, $50 for each Joy Bisco Lumpia Bomb. Are you serious? Can you afford that? Or is this $50 for each of the your current pledge?
How do you do a Joy Bisco Lumpia Bomb? How does that
happen? She doesn't have a Lumpia Bomb yet. Do you have any frozen Lumpia sticks there in a freezer somewhere that you can hold up? Joy, uncooked Lumpia.
You got uncooked Lumpia in your freezer.
Because God knows we do.
Classic.
So 12 on Stewie says, I'll go.
Okay.
I apologize. So Vince says he's working on it. He's got to ask his dad for his credit card. LOL.
He was hustling.
All right, Dad. Woo-hoo! Dad, if you're listening to this, Dad, it's more than $1. It's not $50.
Of the local tips, to get you sent to all the right places. Welcome to town, Lawrence.
Joy, is that your dog? Your dog's cute.
That's
a pug.
Look at that. Roommate.
All right, so
we're.
Aw. Aw, that's not cute.
Aw, doggy.
I just have to stop everything just to look at that. It's hot. It's cute.
That's cute. Did you know these Lumpia bombs make really good fans?
Hey, Bat.
These Lumpia bombs make really good fans too. By the way, look at this.
Yeah. See, that's cool what they were doing in Pizza Hut, and then they threw it in the trash.
They did.
Gene, don't do that, Gene.
No. Okay. No. 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 No, none of that. None of that. Can't have none of that.
All right. So our viewers are still holding steady here. And we're waiting for, let's see, 12-1 Studios. We're waiting for Vince's dad here to represent.
How old is Vince anyway? We're hitting up like an 8-year-old here.
I know. How old is Vince?
We're all asking a 10-year-old for money.
How old is Vince?
Joy, how old is Vince?
Joy.
Hey, Joy.
We lost Joy. I think he's drinking legal.
Oh,
yeah?
Okay, all right.
Oh,
all
right. He's a grown man.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, I can
old
hear
enough
you.
To have a credit card.
But not old enough to have his own credit card yet.
Not yet.
All right, we're just, you know, we've given you a free show now for 3 hours.
Woo-hoo!
We've gotten 4 backers tonight.
Yay!
But no backers in the last hour. So, you know, definitely, this is the last weekend, guys. The last Friday of the campaign. If you happen to be, it's at 12 right now, so it's not yet, the bar hasn't closed yet. Not yet, last call.
We can't stay on, man. They'll be too drunk till for us to...
I know.
We can't stay on that long.
We can't reason with drunk people.
Joy, I think Joy's drunk already.
What? Oh. She's drunk with puppies.
She's drunk off that apple juice.
All right. What say you, viewers? The message board has gotten cold all of a sudden. Have you guys... Because it's past 12... And, you know, now that...
Friday, what the hell?
I hate to say this, guys, but if you go to the Kickstarter page right now, our page has now gone from days to hours. It now says 71 hours to go in our campaign.
Wow.
That's so scary. Oh, man.
It's now... Wow. We're now down to hours now on Kickstarter.
Oh my God, I can't...
Still 51%... 52% away from our goal.
But how do people think they're going to fund this movie if they don't help us? If they don't donate?
That is a good question.
Do they?
That is the million-dollar question. And Adak415 says, hold up, be right back.
Oh!
What are we holding up for?
I don't know.
The showgirls one, right?
I can't.
I think he also is trying to get his credit card. Or maybe asking his dad for a credit card.
Up mom for the credit
card. Yeah. Everyone's asking for the parents for the credit cards. So, you know what? If you're asking someone else, why not use that person's credit card to create a new backer while you're doing it? Then add it to your credit card.
Two new backers with that one card.
Yeah.
Donate
$20.
Two times
each. And we have to remind our viewers that just because you pledge today with your credit card, they don't Kickstarter doesn't even charge your credit card yet. You know, the earliest they'll charge your credit card is September 10th, and that's only if this campaign is successful. So, honestly, you can pledge $10,000 right now and just cancel your pledge before Monday night just to see us drink.
Ed.
That's the sad fact.
You that's can actually messed up, pledge. Man. Don't be giving them ideas.
Another shot. Shot.
That's a great practical joke, though.
For what?
For I don't know who that would be for, but that's messed up, man.
All right, so 12-1 Studios says... Oh, wait. Hold on.
What?
We got 302 backer, 302! Woo!
Whoop-ya-bum!
All right, so this was done from Adak. And he has requested Showgirls clip. So I don't know if there's a
Showgirls clip
favor. You can't send links on this, but if you can help us find a clip from Showgirls on YouTube, Showgirls we will clip. Have AJ Colomai mimic that move.
AJ's right gonna now. Do a Showgirls move. Yes.
Here we go.
Oh wait.
There we go.
Vince Stoney also.
Anna woke up just in time to see AJ do a Showgirls move.
Showgirls, let's
Pull
see.
Down Pat.
That's awesome.
Vince also donated. That's where the 302 came from.
Who was that?
That's my cousin.
Oh, wait.
Vince was a 302 because the DAC is already a donator. Donor.
San Diego.
Okay, so Vincent Velez has joined us as backer number 302. So Vincent, sorry, you are backer 302. Let's see. And Adak 415 hasn't increased his pledge yet.
He hasn't? What?
Oh, he wanted to see your goods before.
So you're safe for now.
Oh, okay.
Go back. All right, go back to
AJ's, the AJ. AJ's sad. He wanted to shake that thing for us.
Shake it.
Look at that. He's all sad now. Look at him.
Aww. How's he going to disappoint this guy?
He totally disappointed him. He's bummed out. Dang.
$50 pledge.
Dad, tell me if I'm wrong. If I'm mistaken, did you increase your pledge? If not, let me know. Now, 12-1 Studios, while we're waiting, 12-1 Studios asking, so no one wants to do the coffee chug, no takers?
Where?
Is the coffee being brewed?
Coffee, dude.
Coffee being brewed? What?
Oh, that was a serious thing. Okay.
Yeah. So there's three. Oh, actually.
Right now?
12-1 Studios wants
a coffee chug. I'm going to work on the chug. Hold on.
Yeah, that's my director right there.
I have a day off, thank goodness, in Chicago now. What up, AJ?
That's my boss.
Kuya says, what up, AJ? Yeah,
what up?
But which AJ are you referring to? A lot of AJs today.
How many?
Eric says, no, LOL, and I don't remember what was the question.
What?
Is that the right? Shout out, Vincent! Thank you, cuz.
Vince, cousin made it.
Right, what's going on here?
Kaosin.
Oh, wait. Kaosin. This is... It's what's it doing?
Pat's reading comments from an hour ago.
That did look familiar.
Time warp.
What's going on? What happened here?
I don't know.
What's it doing?
The comments are, like, jumping down. That's weird. Right.
I think we're catching up.
We have 71 hours to go, fam.
Hey guys, thanks for waiting, but after that, Ega thought.
Hey, AJ, can you recollect the time in history?
Alright, Adak says he added $50 to his pledge.
Where? I don't see it. What?
Who added $50?
Wait, I don't. Oh, Maribel says hello from the motherland.
Aww.
Hello.
Is that Maribel Bustos?
Maribel, hey. We'll see you next week.
What's up, Maribel?
Who's Trent 2003 T-Bro?
All right, so, Adak.
That's
good. Help me find the Showgirls clip for AJ here. I'll try to look for one, too. I'll double check to see if...
I got the 16 ounces.
Whoa.
I got the 16 ounces. What do we got to do about this now? Is it, what is this worth?
It's $1. Yes, Adak, I don't see a $50 increase.
He's about to chug that 16 ounce.
I'm about to chug this. What am I chugging this for? What? Give me some meaning. I need context.
Sriracha sauce instead. That would be cool for a
sriracha sauce.
Motivation.
16 ounces of sriracha sauce. Mm-hmm. That's gonna be nasty.
It's gonna come out nasty.
Nah, totally nasty. Oh my god, that's gonna hurt. That is gonna hurt.
Pledge 25.
Chug the sriracha, Gene. Chug it.
Patricio.
Yes.
What's Gene chugging for?
Oh. Yeah.
Is
John.
Is John changing his pledge?
We miss you too, Maribel. Let's see. 12-1 Studio. So no one wants to do the choffee chug. No takers. But
I got
are
the
you
chug.
Increasing your pledge?
He'll go from 1 to 20.
He's gonna go from $1 to $25.
Can you do it tonight, John?
Do it right now, John.
If you do it right now, Gene's gonna drink his
Gene's coffee. Is ready
I got it
to
right
go.
Here.
Gene's
I got it right
ready
here.
To go, John.
Looking right here.
Right on his lips.
We are ready to rock and roll.
Vincent, thank you again for being backer number. I lost track.
Go, homie.
Vincent Velez.
I'm whoring myself out for you, Pat. I hope you're proud.
I'm waiting for 12-1 Studios. John Raposas. Come on.
You have to start crying now. That's how you're whoring yourself out.
I am about to whore myself out.
Just have some tears flowing.
Ready.
Gonna give my bladder a workout, and I'll be up for the rest of the night. drinking 16 ounces of coffee at 12 midnight.
Did it go through?
Yeah,
I don't think I've ever chugged this much before. This is gonna be. I don't even know if I can do it. We'll try, I guess.
It's not working.
All right, I'm lost in track. Our Thriller from Sarah Manila says both. Thriller from Sarah Manila, keyword today. So I've lost track. Lily, I think I may need you to do the boards because I am confused.
What happened to you? What is wrong? Are you drunk already?
No. Okay, so I still don't know if we're doing the Showgirls thing.
Vincent
Velez. Vincent gave us $1. Are we supposed to do something now for Vincent? I forgot. Or were we just getting him to do be a backer?
We were just getting him to get his dad's credit card.
Okay. Okay, so your credit. Vincent, do you want us to do something for your $1?
Showgirls.
Vincent.
$1 makes me holla.
Well, John is supposed to be changing it to $30 so that Gene can drink that coffee.
Okay, so, so 12-1 Studios is going to change it to $25, $30, right?
Yeah.
So we're waiting for that. None of that has happened yet.
Adak15 swears he made that increase.
$1. Just like the stripper. Yeah.
Maybe you pledge it to a different movie.
Oh, no.
No.
That's movie.
Somewhere, someone else is simulating the Showgirls.
Dude, Gene looks like he's getting ready for that coffee. The coffee shots.
Look at the size of this cup, man. This thing is bigger than my head. God, it's huge.
Just think he's on. Where are you at?
Head, move.
Who's Trent 2003?
Who?
Who's Trent 2003?
I don't know who is Trent 2003. Okay, we have a new backer, Marvin.
Is it 303?
Are we 303? I don't know where my screen is.
Who are you? 303,
guys! Woo! We got 303? 303! It'll be a
ball! Woo! Woo!
Woo! Now, are we gonna do something for Marvin? You know, we're gonna do the chug.
Chug.
Do the coffee chug right here, Gene, for $30.
What,
right
what
here,
am I Marvin. Doing the coffee chug for?
For what Marvin. Just happened?
We're doing it for Marvin. Okay,
we got a new backer. We got a new backer right now.
A new backer.
All right, this large coffee is for you, Marvin, the new backer, right?
Yes.
Right. 303. Okay, here we go.
We've hit an equal 24,200.
I've never chugged this much coffee before. This is like
really.
And that will get you home safely.
Hmm. Okay.
Chug.
All right.
Diet Coke. That's more than that.
Here we go.
Long Beach. Go chug.
Oh God.
Chug. Oh God.
Oh, brain freeze. Okay, hold on. I need to catch my breath. Oh my God!
It didn't
here
make the Jaeger shot, man.
Thanks, Star.
Yay!
Thank you.
And ka-ching.
Ka-ching.
Oh God!
That's gross.
Excuse me, that was nasty. Pardon me.
Oh,
you have to censor that on the
that's the
edited, broadcasted version of this.
Oh, man.
All right, so...
I'm such a whore!
I'm sorry. You are one of our beloved pledges, and I want to keep you happy, so I am going to look for a Showgirls YouTube.
Oh, man.
Let's see.
Showgirls
clip. Anyone that has any chicken from Showgirls for our editor producer AJ Colomai to perform. I see a video here, a YouTube video called Elizabeth Berkley Hot Dancing Showgirls.
Oh, you gotta do your Showgirls dance.
Sexy
now,
scene where Naomi and James freestyle the new dance he's working on in his apartment.
Sweet.
Clip from Showgirls with Elizabeth Berkley.
If I'm whoring myself out, so do you. You gotta whore yourself out too.
Let me see if this is worthy.
Come here.
Hold on, we're gonna see if this is approved by our Lumpia lovers. If this is the scene that
is it?
See, that's for show.
How do I do this?
Tutu. I like how Mary Bell is like out of the country and still listening to us.
I'm awake.
Mary Bell.
I am fucking awake. Yes.
Can you blink your eyes now? Blink them. Close one eye at least.
Hey, Lily.
Yeah, Joy.
What time does your restaurant close?
We don't close.
24/7.
We're marathoning here while we're marathoning with you guys.
That's hardcore, man.
Oh. Fucking hardcore.
Filipino Bakery, right, is the name?
Yes, sir.
In Mira Mesa?
The one near the second? Near the base?
Yeah. It's like south of downtown.
Oh, you're on the other side of town now.
This is our second location.
Oh, wow, no kidding.
If you're in like the gas lamp like you usually are, Gene.
Yeah.
Just a straight shot from Harbor Drive.
Serious?
You won't hit any checkpoints, promise.
So when does it get like super busy there, like after 2?
Sometimes, or even before, like people go clubbing, like 9 or 10. Like right now.
Oh, is that right?
So I'm watching these kids.
So this is the quiet time for you now, then, huh?
A little bit. I could take a nap sometimes, you know. But yeah, Joy, come through, girl. I'll be here like all day tomorrow too.
Tomorrow,
or Sunday also. So 5.
Yeah.
Wow, Lil, you are dedicated, girl. That is hardcore dedication to the family biz right there, man.
I need to eat sometimes. I need to keep my money flowing the way I make it rain all day long.
You must eat well there, though, at that place, yeah?
A little too well, my friend. I can't
do it. Sure, right? Must be tempting, right? All that good food laying around there all day long.
Not a lot of salads here, man.
Yeah, that's true. Filipino food, right?
I got bok choy, but that's probably about it. That's all the greens I get right now.
I've never seen a salad on a Filipino menu. Is that just me?
Well, they make, like, you know, macaroni salad.
Oh, yeah, exactly, with, like, mayonnaise, right? That's Pinoy-style salad, right? Deep-fried.
Yep. All right, so John Raposas has increased his pledge.
Yay! Yay.
And we already drank the coffee. Gene already drank his coffee, John, so I hope you enjoyed that. That was for you. But then maybe for your
pledge. I am amped up.
We're going to do showgirls.
Amped up now, John.
For John Raposas. I just can't play this YouTube video right now.
Wait, did someone increase? Okay, I think someone increased their value.
Yeah, John Raposas just did.
Oh, I see.
Yeah, so now we're going to try to get him a showgirls clip for
eight. So wait, did I drink for John's increase, yes, or did I drink for something else? What did I drink for?
Drank for Marvin.
Oh, I drank for Marvin. Okay.
No, he drank
I can't even remember who I'm whoring myself out to now anymore.
It's okay to know.
All right, so I'm going to show AJ this video clip. Unfortunately, I can't show it to you.
It's the whoring that's important. Okay. But,
look at their eyes. Don't look into their eyes, man. Don't make contact. Just do it. Just make with the whoring.
Exactly. Exactly. It's about the whoring, right?
Kind of is.
Exactly. Just enjoy the whoring part of it. And you will feel fulfilled.
All right, here we go. So we're going to... This is the clip right here.
Oh, this is great. I can't wait to see this.
Watch Elizabeth Berkley.
All right. So let's see. How are we gonna see?
Oh, he needs a partner, though. So, Pat, are you going to do it with him? Which one... AJ, which one are you? Are you going to be Elizabeth Berkley or are you going to be the other guy? Is that a guy or a girl?
The other guy. The other guy.
Yeah, Glenn, what's his name? Isn't that Glenn Plummer or something like that?
That's awesome.
Oh, you two got to do it. You two got to, that's the way to end the show. That is how you end the show. That is an ending, man. That is shows are about endings. That is an ending. The two of you got to do it. Happy ending, that's right. That's the ultimate happy ending.
Can you guys see this or no?
I see it.
Oh, you see it? Okay, let me see
it. It was on screen, now it's back to you two guys.
Oh, hold on. Okay, I have so many of these up, hold on.
Oh, this is great. This is comedy gold, man. This is a new milestone in Pinoy entertainment right here.
Woo! Are you watching this? Oh, boy. Oh, boy.
Oh, that's great. Oh, that's great. Oh, AJ, you gotta do it. Oh, you guys are doing it. You are so doing it.
What has Lucky Cast become?
Oh, Lord.
This is great.
Let's just do this first part.
AJ is going to do everything before he sits on him. She sits on him. I think you're going to do this here. Right.
You're not going to do the bump and grind? Come on, man. You got to do the bump and grind.
Gene, you're going to have to be bump and
grind. Yeah, right there.
Oh, my God.
There you go. It's just doing it right now. Wait. You can't see it. Hold on. No one can see this.
Hey, the boy's awake.
Baby's awake.
Baby, don't watch.
Wow.
Don't watch that.
Look at how handsome he is.
Okay, right, here we go. We're going to do this, AJ.
He can't watch the showgirls thing.
Can he watch the showgirls thing, Joy? Is that okay for him to watch?
He has to learn how he was made.
Okay, there you go.
Right, this is the high kick right here.
This is so, this is so not family friendly.
Oh, shit. Oh, shit. Loop your ball.
Wait, it's frozen.
Okay.
Stop turning off your camera.
Wait, it's frozen. Why? We missed it. I want to see it again. Encore. It totally froze. You guys made it freeze on purpose. We can't see it.
Well, what happened? Did you see that? They freeze? What happened?
What the hell just happened? AJ, go to Gene and do it up there.
AJ kicked me so hard, it kicked the webcam.
We couldn't see the downstairs camera. You gotta do it upstairs.
It was too hot. Right, it was too hot for the downstairs camera.
Didn't see it.
Okay, yeah, do it again.
Oh, hold on. Okay. I gotta replay the video for them. Hold on.
Spin around, AJ. Do it. Spin.
Just don't kick me again. Oh, I heard it. Damn it, my fucking neck. Hold on. Warm up, AJ. Warm up.
His face is so serious.
Okay, so he just woke up.
Oh, Bisco.
What's up?
Hello. Okay,
let's go. Let's do this.
Hey, Bisco wants to see some showgirls.
That's right. He's watching. He's watching. He's trying to learn some moves.
Hello, baby.
All right, here we go.
Okay, here we go.
So if you guys just look up youtube.com/watch?v=... Zero B N F K G F E S Q W.
Just Elizabeth Berkley hot dancing.
Let's do Elizabeth Berkley hot dancing showgirls.
Yeah, let's go. Let's
39 seconds into clip right now. We're watching it. Here we go.
Babe.
Are you seeing this? This is great.
That's too much.
That is awesome.
Oh shit. Oh, high kick. Oh, this is the grinding part. This is where I stop.
No bump and grind? No bump and grind?
No. Yes. Gene, now it's up to Gene to do part two. Gene's going to do part two, the grinding part.
I'm going to do bump and grind?
I'm going to run upstairs and give Gene the...
So 128.
Come on up here. Let's go book the bump and grind.
Right now. Here you go. Gene's going to get a grinding right now. There we go.
Wait, how do we do the bump and grind? Whoa!
That's that lumpia.
Oh my gosh, we work hard for our money.
All right, so our goal is to hit 25K still here. We are still.
We're like Donna Summer up in this bitch, man. You know, like working hard for that
we're
money.
Still 700.
Working hard for that money.
$61 away. Any takers for this to hit 25K, please?
Wait, so what's up?
Oh, man.
All right, so Baby Bisco has woken up.
Hi, Baby Bisco.
If he can speak, he wants you.
He is handsome.
Hit 25K tonight.
That is a handsome young man right there. That is a handsome little fella.
Can you tell all the Lumpy lovers out there to pledge and back that Lumpia, please?
Say lumpia.
Oh.
Now, come on. That deserves a pledge right there, right? Come on. Oh, yay, Baby Bisco.
That's too cute.
Still have steady viewership going on here. Comment board, Lily. What were they saying? Are they any other takers?
Vince said, "Hey, Baby Bisco." John said, "Thank you, Gene."
He finally did increase his pledge. And
we just did the show, girls. We fulfilled.
No responses. I think everyone is in shock right now.
Don't know how to react to that one.
They don't. They're like, what did we just see? This is like magical.
That was crazy.
A unicorn.
You're gonna hear about it tomorrow, though. Hey.
That was crazy. Backers.
We did get 7 backers tonight, but we're still short of our 25k goal. So listen up. I know you have friends. There are viewers watching this. I know the people in the household. It's Friday night. There's no way you're by yourself. Oh, thank you, Leslie to Lusan. Why?
Oh, 304, man. 304. Wait.
The last pledge?
Yes. Is 304 a new one? 304?
Is 304 a new one? Hold on.
I think it is. You were at 303
there. We're so behind. Let me check.
Is 304 a new one?
Frozen.
Come on.
Aya. We're in Filipino time here.
You're good.
All right. Yes! 304 backer! And...
304.
Brian has increased his pledge. So we got two! Two Lumpia Bombs! Woo! Les, thank you for your pledge, and thank you for that sandwich CD. I hope you got my props out to you. Yeah. I met Quirk, and you should just meet to that scene. So... back down, Lumpia. Thank you for backing down, Lumpia, Les. We miss you. All right, and also, Brian increased his pledge. So thank you, Brian, for increasing his pledge. Now, we are at, let's see.
I don't know how those like morning radio show guys do it. They're on the air for like 4 hours straight every morning.
They have technicians and all that stuff.
Man.
Talk radio.
Talk radio 4 hours every day. My God, I'm exhausted already.
Let's do this.
You shouldn't be with all that coffee, Gene.
I know, man. Jeez.
We're looking for a $50 shot now. We're gonna take another shot.
Yeah. Oh God.
Jaeger for $50. I think we have enough people here who are listening.
It's nice that you guys are doing that.
So $50 will take another shot of Jaeger.
$50
wants another shot of Jaeger. So $50, either increase your pledge $50, or new backer $50. $50, that's all we're asking. They don't even charge your credit card until Tuesday.
$50 for another shot.
Come on, let's do this. All right,
I'm gonna get my shot glass.
Backers, $50. We're asking for $50. $50. Any takers out there? We'll take another shot. I don't have any other requests. My back for 5, we got your updated pledge, we did the showgirls thing, anything else you want to see, my friend?
They did request it, and they did see it.
Yes, we're looking for another challenge, we're still here. Joy Bisco is still in the house. We have Gene Kahayan, who isn't planning to be here, he's still in the house. Lillian Primola, the two producers, still in the bakery.
Still at work.
And we're still doing this. It's 21 minutes past our deadline, and we're still on because you are still here. So we're gonna stay here for another 30 minutes because we can only last. We can't go more than 4 hours. So I think.
Lane.
Yes. YouTube video has to end. So there's not much time. Let's go, and we have to get some sleep because tomorrow's FPAC. All right. So while we're waiting for the pledges. Again, we're going to be having our last stand this weekend at FPAC. It's so loud over there. But FPAC right now, this weekend, we're going to be there at the BucketY.com booth.
Yeah,
all current Kickstarter backers, visit us. We'll give you a movie poster. All new pledges, even a dollar will get you your free movie poster. You'll even get one of these new Lumpia fists, second printing. And yes, the goal is to hit
20K
goal. But tonight we want to hit 25K. So we're going to take us out there, 25K.
I think.
Someone's going to donate 25K. That would be awesome.
Then lumpia will really get made.
Oh, okay, yeah.
Have to push it back.
Yeah.
Patricio,
have I...
Try it again.
Caravel's asking me, have I approached Apple to be an executive producer? And I think I answered that question the other day.
Are you going to be a pro what?
I'm proud of myself. I got my shot glass, and I also did 6 more lumpia bombs.
If Apple the app is listening to this right now, we're live. Apple, give me a call. We need to talk.
Is Apple the app around? Is he watching this right now?
Apple, call him up.
From judging the Voice Philippines, and I know he has a break. He's watching this right now. He's probably watching me to make. He wants to make me sweat this out. So to the end. But Apple, if you're hearing this, it'd be nice to have you up on board, at least to be part of our webcast and join the Olympia cast here. Again, we're going to be at FPAC this weekend. The shot has been poured. We're waiting for that $50 pledge. So who's going to be, is it going to be Backer 3 or 5? Is going to give us a $50 pledge, at least a $50 pledge? Is it going to be any of you current backers out there? Who's going to crease it? Again, another $50?
We have it right here.
So, we're waiting.
If Gene dances, will they pledge $50 while we take
shots? Oh, Maribel wants to say, Gene, are you going to dance for us? Maribel, you missed the RoboCop.
Sure, I'll dance.
But he'll dance.
I'll dance.
The third world internet sucks. Keep freezing.
Can he do an interpretive dance?
Interpretive dance.
Sprockets.
Pick a movie. Is there a movie out there that we did Showgirls? What's a movie out there you want us to reenact?
Dirty Dancing.
Rockets.
Brown.
Bada. Mm.
Let us know. We have a shot, though. Shots for us, $50. $100 for a movie clip. How about that? So $50, we'll take the shot. $100, you pick the movie. AJ will take a break, but we'll have Gene dance the next movie clip. How about that?
Oh. I'll dance.
Lumbada, Gene.
Lumbada.
$50 and $100.
Uh-oh. He's ready to take off his
shirt. Yes, Adak. I like that Dave Bautista retweet, too, but it'd be sweeter if he pledged.
I'm loopy from all the stuff you're having
Bautista,
me
Bautista, if you're listening to this right now.
I think Mel spiked my drink just now. I'm feeling loopy right now.
Pledge. Please drop to I know you have nothing to do while they paint your skin green.
What?
So please, back that lumpia, make a pledge. But thanks for the retweet and loving that lumpia, Bautista. All right. Where are we at? We're still waiting for something here. I still have the shot here. Jor, are you going to have your apple juice shot?
Those are Red Bull shots, homie.
Oh, Red Bull shots.
That was Red Bull?
Look at we're keeping Joy Best. We're keeping Joy Bisco from sleeping. She's getting tired right now.
She's a mommy.
Come on. While we have her here, see, she's giving us her time here.
Hey, sup, Lumpia?
She loves lumpia.
See, she loves lumpia. But you know who else loves lumpia? The Thriller from Sierra Manila, our new EP, Danny Rubio! Woo! Thriller from Sierra Manila!
Wait, Maribel says she might be able to work some magic. What does this mean?
Alright!
Good.
They are requesting Dirty Dancing. Do the lift from Dirty Dancing.
Oh, the lift from Dirty Dancing.
You know
dancing?
Who actually does a good lift from the Dirty Dancing?
Can I lift you, AJ?
Moon Moon.
What do you weigh,
Moon
like 160?
Moon Moon does a great impersonation of the 16? Dirty Dancing lift. Because you can't put Moon Moon in the corner.
Don't put Moon Moon in the corner.
Yes, don't put Moon Moon in the corner.
He's going to cry.
I can lift AJ.
Do it.
How much is this do the lift and dirty dancing? $100? Increase your pledge for $100. $50 shots. So for $100 you get the dirty dancing jean and a Jaeger shot. That's a deal.
The dirty dancing is going to be me doing the lift. The lift.
Yes,
for
the dirty dancing lift.
I'm going to lift AJ.
Yes.
Like that.
Not the other lift. That
right,
lift.
The lift. I'm going to lift. Yeah. You know, it's like romantic and stuff.
Not the dirty lift. The dirty dancing.
It's like, you know, it's like man love. You know, it's good. It'll be good. It's worth it. It's worth the money.
And just so you know, why everyone's in the house, Why are we here in the house, Gene, right now? Why is Gene and...
We are making thousands of these. We are making, like, literally, what, like a thousand of these?
Is there a way to see the assembly line right now? Can we actually see the assembly line from there or no?
Yeah, sure.
Can we not see the assembly line?
You see that? Well, there's AJ's taking a break because we wore him out with the showgirls thing. Yeah. It's like he can't handle it.
He's in the green room right now, getting ready.
And Mel, and I don't know if you can see Anna in the background.
Again, handcrafted with love. So,
way back there. So they're all making thousands and thousands of lumpia bombs.
So if you're an FPAC this weekend, you get this. Please do not throw this in the ground. Do not throw in the trash.
We worked hard to make these.
Working on these handcrafted collectibles.
Worked hard to make these things.
We gotta give props out to uprinting.com for printing these up, by the way. Our LA sponsor.
You know I own.
Uprinting.com. You know I own. Thank you, Uprinting.
I had no idea those guys were Pinoy.
We're still waiting for a $20 pledge here.
$20 pledge? What?
No, $20 pledge. Did I just lower my... Oh, my God. This is how disorienting it is past midnight.
You are drunk.
$50!
You totally missed my husband.
For us to take the shot. Oh, someone's that, Joy?
You totally missed Philip. He was saying hi.
Oh, I know.
Philip has lost interest in this now.
No, I did. Philip was by. He said,
oh, Philip. Where's Philip?
What's up, Philip?
Philip, everyone, welcome Philip. Where's Philip? Hello, Jean-Marie. Philip Jean-Marie. Philip Jean-Marie. Philip Jean-Marie.
Looks like we missed our opportunity.
Philip Jean-Marie. Philip Jean-Marie. Philip Jean-Marie. Philip Jean-Marie. Philip Jean-Marie. Philip Jean-Marie. Philip Jean-Marie.
There he is.
Philip Jean-Marie. Welcome to Philip Jean-Marie.
Daddy-o.
Love that lumpia, Philip.
What's up,
man? Say hi to lumpia lovers.
What up, lumpia lovers?
What's up? Tell them they have to pledge and back that lumpia.
Some money. Give him some money, please.
We can pay Joy Bisco to do the narration for this. You gotta support the Bisco.
Let me hold $20.
What's up, Philip?
Stuck on the pledge, guys. Hope you guys get mad money, dude, for real.
Thank you, Philip.
Hey, Philip, congratulations on your son. He's handsome.
Oh, thanks, man. Kind of takes it after me, except he's
yeah,
not.
Yeah, you know. That's right. The two of you created a beautiful child. Congratulations.
Yay for beautiful babies.
Two browns make a Chinese boy.
Woo!
We got nothing to do but... Wait, hold on. Did we get a pledge?
No, I didn't see it.
We still need to hit the 25K.
We
have all these guests. I'm giving you Joy Bisco, Philip Jean-Marie, Gene Kahayan, Philip Perholas, maybe some dirty dancing showgirls. Oh, not dirty dancing. We're pulling out the stops here on a Friday night.
I'm not kidding. AJ and I are gonna do the lift from Dirty Dancing if that pledge comes in. We're totally gonna do that if that pledge comes in.
AJ's gonna wear the dress for free.
Is it that scene where Ryan Reynolds does it in that movie he did with the redhead chick?
Oh yeah, exactly. Yeah, when he runs up and then I grab him and I hold him up. We're totally gonna do that right here on this couch. We're gonna do the lift. We're gonna lift this brother up. It's gonna be beautiful.
Okay, so we have something here on a Facebook comment saying auctioning off a date with Joy Bisco. Is that allowed? Auction off a date with Joy Bisco, LOL. I thought you were going to say who said this. Joy, how do you, what say you, Joy Bisco?
If my son can chaperone, I might have to clear it with my husband, but...
Yes.
Heard that here first, Mr. Raymond Verrata. Actually, I should know the day with Joy Bisco, LOL, but we're gonna R-O-F-L this.
I'm surprised it took somebody that long to ask that question. I thought that would have been asked like at 9:30 or something, you know?
It was actually asked 41 minutes ago. I just checked my phone.
Okay, gotcha.
Is that on Twitter?
It was on Facebook.
Facebook?
Squatting?
Old school.
I haven't been checking Facebook, damn.
Okay, we have someone who wants to join, but I'm going to call him. Lily, can you read the comments board while I try to get someone in here?
We have, let's see, where did we leave off at? Adak415 talks, oh wait, you already said that. Listen, Maribel says, Pat, I might be able to work some magic for you. I don't know what that
magic
means.
Magic.
Hey everyone, welcome Leroy David to the Loopy Cow.
Leroy, what's up?
That's awesome. Leroy.
Yeah, barely. Yeah.
Rockbiter.
Where's your webcam?
It's the connection here is my Wi-Fi connection here. That's what makes it also difficult to do the webcast also.
I want to do more Lumpia Bombs. Can you have me the glue gun?
What do you want to say to the Joy Bisco and G-Kai?
Is that going to mess things up?
Yeah,
okay. Alright. I'm going to bring the laptop over. Is that okay? Can I just unplug it?
Yeah, I love y'all.
Aww.
Love your Congratulations.
Yeah, it's much after.
Get that Leroy Joyce up.
Oh yeah, no, I can't hear.
And now you want
wine?
Gene, you're so loud, Gene.
Am I so loud? Sorry, I moved our station so that we can make some more Lumpia bombs here. So I can feel like I'm multitasking. I'm on the thing and I'm also making more Lumpia
bombs. So let's angle it so that we can see the Lumpia bombs on the table then while you're doing it. And Leroy.
There you go.
Leroy, I like that Bautista retweet. How did that feel?
Yeah, I know. That was the ultimate geek out moment right there. So it was I didn't think he'd still remember me. Yeah.
We'll explain that. Start from the beginning for the people who didn't see the tweet or the picture. What happened?
All right. So I hit up, for those of you not familiar, David Bautista, former WWE wrestling champion. He's also half Pinoy, half Greek. When I used to work for Tower Records years ago, I used to host a lot of autograph signings with wrestlers. Dave Bautista was kind of up and coming. He's been around the independent circuit for a while, but the talk was about him being half Filipino, so there was this, you know, sense of like Pinoy pride and stuff like that. When they did a WWE show in the Bay Area, so I was able to land a signing with Bautista and.
This
was 2005. So we did the event. Me and him talked a lot actually. And I was able to land him an interview with Steve Angeles, from ABS-CBN, who was working up here in the Bay Area, and I was able to get Dave Bautista's like first ever interview on. Maybe at CBN, so that was like a big deal for him because he's always had this Filipino pride, and I think when he got famous, through wrestling, that's when people started to recognize like his ethnicity, and. he definitely wanted to. He wanted to show his pride, and so I got him an interview with Evangelist from ABS-CBN, and we chopped it up, and
there you go, better, right?
You know, yeah. He was just really humble and really cool, and then actually a year later, I bumped into him at another signing in the Bay Area. In Daly City, actually, somewhere atop of the hill, and he, 1 year later, he actually remembered me, my name and all, which was a trip, and we talked it up, and we were talking about, like, you know, Philam, and I told him about Philam Cuisine, you know, about some of the restaurants, you know, Daly City and stuff that he should check out, and I think that was about it, you know, and you know, obviously, he, you know, continued his career, and then he, of course, he left wrestling and got into, you know, Hollywood. And so I would just follow him on Twitter. And I used to get, like, I used to hit him up on Twitter early on. And I would get, like, you know, reply, like, once in a blue moon. And then I figured with the Lumpia campaign, I figured I, you know, would just give it a try. And next thing you know, I got a retweet and a reply from him, and that was definitely ultimate geek out moment for me.
That's awesome. Now we just need him to get Pledge.
You know, the thing.
Good job, Leroy.
The stat. I look at the stats. I mean, we got, you know, a handful of, like, retweets and favorites, you know, from that tweet itself, and. But, you know, whether people pledged or not, it's hard to say, but, you know, on the bright side, I mean, we were able to get some exposure, and, you know, and honestly, you know, Dave Bautista doesn't, you know, he doesn't really retweet a lot of things or, you know, any type of, you know, somewhat, I should say, like, an endorsement or whatever, but I would almost call this like an unofficial endorsement. The fact that he, you know, retweeted, you know, our Kickstarter link, you know, to his followers, and we're talking about, you know, 400,000 plus followers. So, you know, any type of exposure like that, you know, it's a big deal, you know.
Well, you know, he's not doing anything. I'm sure as he's being painted green. For Drax the Destroyer. He's just sitting in his chair and needs something to do. So, Bautista, the next time you're being painted green for Drax the Destroyer in the Guardians of the Galaxy movie for Marvel, you can just visit lovethatlupia.com and back that Lupia!
Woo! Yes, sir.
And, Leroy. How do you feel now? It says you're 70. It says now 71 hours to go on a Kickstarter page. Not even days anymore. It's 71 hours.
Pretty nervous. And you know, been making some last minute, you know, calls and you know, trying to get folks to you know, really push it out. You know, a lot of direct messaging, you know, on Facebook, Twitter, and, you know, really trying to touch base with, you know, even our supporters, and whom we've probably, you know, whom others probably have messaged as well, and really just trying to, you know, help them to push out and hopefully pledge some more and stuff, and, you know, that's pretty much what my tactic is going to be for the next, you know, 72 hours, so.
Yeah, and the thing is, what people need to understand is that if we don't make our goal on Monday night, 11:59 p.m., we don't get any of it.
Nada.
The Olympia 2 project actually gets canceled. And all of this, all the pledges that we're doing right now, all the Olympia backers now who have actually put money in, increased their pledges, none of that even counts anymore. So I'm not just saying this to the to get more pledges and backers. I'm also saying that to the current backers that it's also important to continue to be active and to tell your friends and convince your family why it's important to pledge. And they don't even get charged until Tuesday morning.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, it's we're definitely relying on the strength of our current backers right now. And you know, if every 300 plus backers, you know, can tell 10 of their friends, and hopefully those 10 friends can tell 10, and hopefully the power of 10, you know, can help us, you know, reach our goal by Monday, and especially for this weekend. This is definitely a very eventful weekend. I know you guys are going to be over at FPAC. I'm not sure how many. I've never attended FPAC. Not sure what how many people are expected to be there, but that'd be really awesome if we can get everybody at FPAC to donate.
Or we can just get Dave Bautista just to click the button and just end this right now. Or Apple the App. Apple the App, where you at? Bebo. You can end this now, Apple. Just return my calls, please. I know, man. Come on, dude. I did 3 music videos for you. All I ask is just you return my calls. I'm just kidding. These people are in touch with me.
Just kidding. Not really, but...
Not really. 71 more hours left to contact Apple. Save us. All right, Leroy, any last words? We got to go here. We only have 20 minutes left in our YouTube telecast, so we still have a shot here left. I'm still holding my shot. $50 pledge. We still need a $50 pledge here. $100, and Gene's going to do the dirty dancing lift.
That's right, with AJ.
With AJ.
AJ.
That's a cheap discount, man. And the thing is, what sucks is that if this Kickstarter campaign doesn't fall through, this is still going to be on YouTube. So,
forever.
You know, this is forever.
Forever.
The pledge is just today.
That's kind of scary.
So, anyway, Leroy, any last few words? We got to go. I'm going to let you go, but a few moments. Say anything to Joy, Lily, Gene, AJ?
Absolutely. Please love that Lumpia. You know, make Lumpia 2 happen. You know, we need this. We need to do this. And I believe.
Yes, I believe. And Leroy agreed with me that everyone has permission now to annoy, spam, post, email, prank call all your friends and buddies, because you do it with your passion and heart. So you can do it this weekend. I'm giving you permission. It's not called spam. It's called spam musubi. It's done with more love. So spam musubi all your buddies and loopy lovers out there, guys. We are 25,000 still left to go. But right now, we're just looking for a $50 pledge. While we say goodbye, Leroy. To everyone. Bye, Leroy.
Bye, Leroy.
Bye, Leroy.
Bye, Leroy.
Bye, Leroy. Bye, Leroy. All right, so you guys, we have only 20 minutes left. We have to cut out from this webcast because we can't go over 3-4 hours on this. So first things first, we do need a $50 pledge here. And we still have, how many viewers? We still have viewers watching us right now. Lily, what's on the comments board?
The comments board, hold on. Let me check. Let's see. Maribel says, "Joy, your baby's so, your boy is so cute."
Thanks, Maribel.
So cute.
Let's see. A Doc 415 says Bautista and Leroy are BFFs. And he also wants Leroy to take off his anything. So Leroy, FYI.
It's all about the nudity.
On the nudity when he's over the phone.
I don't know.
about it. Not too many people.
All right, and I think this is a cue for us to take our shots regardless.
Shots.
All right, guys, so we're going to take a shot here. We didn't get our pledge. I am still hopeful that we'll pull through. So yes. Cheers, everyone.
Shots.
Lumpia bomb.
Can you shot list?
Different kind of Jaeger bomb.
Come on, Anna Bautista Calame.
ABC. Got
to do a shot list.
Damn.
Everybody, shots.
What should I do for this?
Public drinking.
Bisco, Bisco.
I want to tell you something.
Go ahead, Bisco. Okay. You have permission to go ahead.
That was profound, man. That's profound.
Bisco has spoken.
He's saying, all right.
And that's how we will react on Monday night when we pass this Kickstarter campaign, everyone.
Yeah.
We believe, everyone. So yeah. Again, quick announcements. This weekend we'll be at FPAC. It is the last stand. We also have a video and new rewards to announce tomorrow. We still have one last episode of Geeking Out While Eating Lumpia. You saw the first episode with Dante Bosco. The second episode was with filmmaker Quark Nares. The Lumpia Invitational by Xylophone Films came out this week. Have you checked that out yet? And that video is three chefs fighting to create the Lumpia that will be casted in the next Lumpia 2 film. And I'm a judge there with Jen from Rocket Y. It's a pretty funny segment, so check that out. And again, we have the new Geeking Out While Eating Lumpia episode premiering this weekend some point while I get some time to edit it and finish it. And I'll be with Wilsh Portacio and Justin Keyson, who wanted to see me shirtless tonight.
Wilsh.
We are nearing... It's intimidating. 71 hours left. 304 backers. $24,000.
That's a cool shot.
As of Friday night. And as you see, our Lumpia team is hard at work here making these Lumpia bombs. This is a Kickstarter campaign for Lumpia 2. And we're having fun with this. And I hope you guys enjoy the Lumpia cast. Final words from Lily Perjoles.
Please, please, please support. I did ask earlier, like, if we don't do this, but you still want to see Lumpia, I don't know how else you would see it without support.
Well, don't forget our shot.
So please, please check us out, please support, and just know that what you're doing is important.
Oh, yeah.
Not a lot of studios can do this. Know that you can help us do this. Please do.
Thank you, Lily. And Joy Bisco.
I want nothing. Wishing, and please, if you got extra change in your pocket, push it on down to push so they can make them. You guys gotta pimp out though at FPAC, man. Plus a dollar for every single person.
Yeah, and you get a free movie poster with that, and a free handcrafted
here also.
Movie bomb. I mean, I can't think of a better deal for that for your mission to FPAC. So please come out and support movie lovers. Any last words from Gene? I think they're still busy. Any last words from you guys from the Snoopy Bomb assembly line factory?
You guys know what's up. We're here on a Friday night making Lumpia bombs. You know we're supporting a good cause. Come on out to FPAC over the weekend, get your own Lumpia bomb, and make that donation, even if it's only a dollar. A dollar makes us holler. A dollar is awesome. That'll work.
All right, and so the announcement today that I want to say is something I already know already, and I really want to bring in. And for Joy Bisco, she's returning as the narrator for Lumpia 2, for sure. It's just now a matter of just raising the funds to pay her, guys. So please back that Lumpia. Hey, Joy Bisco, is that okay? Can you be at least the narrator for Lumpia 2?
Said okay.
Is that okay?
she said okay because he thinks you're talking to him. Because you said.
Oh, so Bisco has approved us. No.
Oh, he thinks you're talking to him. He doesn't know my name is Bisco.
Oh, Joy. Mama.
Mama, my name is Bisco, too.
So Mama is the narrator for Lumpia 2. Bisco, do you want your mom to be the narrator for Lumpia 2?
Alright.
Yay, he says alright. Alright. So we have Joy Bisco back on Lumpia 2. That's our announcement today, tonight. Joy, thank you again for joining us. It is great. I have to see you and we catch up in person. Lily again, you won't be here this weekend, but please do your part. Get San Diego to back that Lumpia this weekend. Leroy just joined us. He's going to get the Bay Area to back us up. See here, the whole factory coming up here to do the Lumpia Bombs. Meet us over at FPAC tomorrow morning. Hopefully be well rested. We'll be there Saturday and Sunday. Say hi. Back that Lumpia. And we'll see you later. So I'm going to say goodbye to Joy Bisco first. Bye, Joy.
Bye. You got y'all.
Shot.
Shot lead.
Shot.
Oh, yes, we took the shot already. You guys missed the shot.
You took the shot already?
Take it.
All right,
They got so busy. They got so busy, they forgot. So wait, hold on. Let's witness a shot here.
Hey guys, join us. Thank you.
All right, girls. Lumpia shot.
Lumpia shot.
1 hour ago. We believe, guys.
Wow. Woo! Okay, back to work.
Thank you, Joy. We'll see you later, Joy. We'll catch up soon. Thank you for joining us for Lumpia 2.
Guys.
Thank you, Joy.
Bye. Have fun tomorrow, guys.
Thank you, baby.
All right, we're going to say bye to the factory. Goodbye, guys, at the Lumpia Bomb Factory.
Help us.
So remember, this is not a real bomb. All right? We're not bombing, you guys. This is a Lumpia Bomb. And of course we're going to say goodbye to Lillian Perhola at the Filipino Food and Bakery. If you're in the San Diego area and never had Lumpia or any of the other combos and pandesal they have there, come check them out on Main Street. See you later, Lily. Thank you so much, Lumpia 2 producer. And I know we have viewers over here, and now it's just me. I do want to take the time in this last, before we have to go. I first off, I want to thank everyone really, as we near the end of this campaign. I really want to thank everyone from all of us here at Lumpia for the support you've given us. I mean, the fact that we've gotten 304 backers and $24,000 is amazing. You know, unfortunately, we still have a bigger goal to go to, and it is daunting thinking about what we're trying to do. But you know, this weekend is going to be a very career defining moment for me, because I really want to create Lumpia 2, and the more that we do this, the more we get into it. It makes me want to make the movie more. And unfortunately, this movie Lumpia 2 will only happen if we really make our goal. And I hear everyone, you know, at all the screenings, everyone has told me personally that, is it true that you're gonna cancel Lumpia 2 if you don't make your goal? And honestly, to tell you the truth, my answer right now is yes. You know, it is not easy to make these kind of films, and for me, for the past 10 years, this is what I've done. You know, I've made movies because I love the community, and I made projects without budgets, and I did it because I loved it. And I don't do this because I expect anything in return. You know, I don't want to say that if this Lumpia campaign fails, that it's because the community didn't come out and support. It's because we still need to build our audience. There are people out there who are big fans of this film, who want to see more movies like this, and it's up to us to see it happen. So So the one thing that I want to reiterate is to please help us out. This weekend is our last stand at FPAC, and while we're there, the least you can do for watching this right now, because the viewers watching this right now, is to please, you know, tell your friends, email them. You know, Kickstarter probably has a bad name because there's a lot of it, and people are just tired of it, people are putting it out, but talk to them about the project. You know, I know a lot of you guys are educators, you know, people who use these films I've done a lot of talks in colleges, you know, about representation and stuff, and nothing would make me happier to I don't know what to say. This is tough. It has been a crazy 30 days, you guys, and I'm honored that there are so many people out here. I was trying to avoid to politicize this whole movement because all I really wanted to do is create a fun movie with a sequel. And I do get the messages from all these filmmakers out there who are inspired by this movement. And I don't want to let you guys down. So I want so hard. That's why we're working so hard. You know, we're creating original content for this Kickstarter campaign. We've never done this before. This campaign is something that for us is a platform to promote other artists, and I think that's the reason why we created all these segments is because we were having fun with it. We want to promote other people who are working hard and love this community. What it comes down to really is I guess the question comes down to, is it worth making movies for the film community? And this is something I've fought for a long time. And it is something that I think that for me as a filmmaker, trying to figure out, because for the past 10 years, if you've followed our work, myself and AJ, we've done so many projects with no budgets, low budgets, you know, and you know, we do it because we love the music, we love the community, and we never really expected anything in return. And this campaign has forced us, for the first time, to feel like we're begging you guys for money to selfishly fund our own project. And while that's the case, it seems, because we're doing the Lumpia 2, it's become, as we're going deeper in this campaign, become something bigger. And, you know, for me, being on tour with the debut made me realize how blessed I was to visit a lot of the other people out there outside California. I guess for me, I guess what motivates me is to see that momentum again, see that when I saw what happened, what the debut was able to do in theaters and get everyone, all generations, together in the same theater, that was very uplifting, you know, and to a point where I don't think there's been a movie since then that has done that for a community. Now, I'm not saying that Lumpia 2 is going to do that exactly, but Lumpia 1 was created with just a bunch of kids who got together, you know, and didn't care about, they didn't think that this, you know, we didn't do it because we wanted to show off or we knew that this movie was going to go out there and we're going to become famous or something. It was just a bunch of us got together, start a movie, make a movie on our own, and just because we enjoyed each other's company. And then, for some reason, the movie found a cult following. And now with Lumpia 2, we're trying to do it again. But this time, instead of this small Daly City community, this is a community project. I want everyone else outside of Daly City, fans of the Lumpia, to come in and join the party. And I think this is the only reason why Lumpia 2 can be funded by the community. You know, I don't think this movie can be made by any studio, whether it's mainstream or independent. This is a movie that can only be made by the community. The same way how it was done in Daly City with my neighbors. And so, if this is something you believe in and you really want to see this through, you know, all I can say is, you know, please help us out this weekend. At the very least, you know, share it with other people. I'm just trying to find the words to really right now I'm just totally meltdown right now because I don't I really don't know what to say, you know, and I've written so many messages to people, and I apologize to all my friends and stuff who I've given, you know, I've probably written more personal emails and spams and posts more than I can tell, you know, and I rarely ask for favors, you know, and usually it's always the other way around, right? It's usually people asking me favors and me and Mr. Nice Guy and things. If I believe in the project, I'll make it my own passion project, and that's all I've been doing for the last 10 years. So, I really want to make Lumpia 2. It's come to a point now as I'm getting deep into this where it was just this Kickstarter campaign was just really a way to see if there was an audience for it. And as I get into it, and after the screening last night of people rediscovering Lumpia and people who've seen it and they're watching it last night, it hit me finally that this is a movie that I had to make, but I can't do it for less than $50,000, you know, and you know, I'm not getting any younger, you know, I'm nearing 40, and I know I don't have many movies left in my tank or music videos, and I guess what happens on Monday night will literally define what kind of projects I do after that point. I will never lose my passion for the community, no doubt, but when it comes to, you know, worthwhile financially and trying to sustain a career, there comes a point where I have to start thinking about making this career financially viable for myself. I've been able to balance that out because I'm very fortunate to have a full-time job. But I think it's time for me to take it to the next level, and I'm really asking for you guys to help me out, help us out to make Lumpia 2, and really, you know, just get on the bandwagon and let's make a kick-ass movie together. Because Lumpia 1 movie, you know, we did it with our small community, and I think it just makes sense to do it together. And I'm sorry, it's late. It's already 1:25 a.m., and I know you guys are still watching this, yeah, 71 hours left, and And we're still trying to be resilient here and be strong, and we're going to finish strong because there's still a lot of stuff we have to squeeze in for the last 2-3 days. But the least you can do, I know some of you backed us up, and I'm very, very humbled at the fact that there are so many people who are believing in us, and I get the emails, and I get the personal messages. I get all your Facebook posts. I see it. I read it. I wish I had time to respond to everyone. But we still have a lot of work to done, and every free time I have, I'm doing something, whether it is to finish editing the segment for Geeking Out that I haven't finished yet, or to make even more emails and personal pleas. This is not an easy thing to do, and for me to put us out there, and I know there are a lot of people sacrificing. You saw it earlier. I mean, people are in my house right now making these Lumpia bombs, It's just very humbling that people will go out of their way to help me. And so all I ask is that if you're watching this right now, to please grab 10 more people. Grab 10 people this weekend. That's all my challenge to you guys, is find 10 people to pledge. I mean, at least $10, you know. Hopefully more than that. But we are now down to the crunch time. All right, I'm going to end this cast right now. And, you know, I don't want to take much of your time already. It is Friday night. We still got a lot to do, and I got to rest for tomorrow. But come on out to the booth in FPAC. Say what's up to us. Motivate us to get in here because, you know, we've been working really hard, and I know our team here could really use the extra boost. I know we're still a long way from our goal, but I believe that we can still do this. So there's nothing more than I like being the underdog. So, you know, with being bottom of the ninth, you know, down by runs, and, you know, I don't know. We'll see what happens this weekend. But thank you, guys. I love you all. And peace out. We'll see you at FPAC this weekend. And back that lumpia. See ya.